Are you dealing with a personal injury? Don't go it alone. Turn to the experienced team at Phillips Law Firm. Their attorneys have helped thousands of clients get the compensation they deserve. Call Phillips Law Firm now. Call 1-800-JUSTICE or visit justiceforyou.com.
Looking to give the gift of pleasure? Add a little high heat to keep the desire burning. Or maybe you just need a little self-care. Come to Lovers for the best lingerie and toys to keep things hot this holiday. Save 20% on your purchase with Lovers Afterglow Rewards. Just mention LOVE20 at one of our 18 Western Washington locations. Offer valid with free Lovers Afterglow Rewards membership until November 30th. Some exclusions apply.
Your home is going into foreclosure and you feel like a financial wreck. You don't know where to turn for accurate information. I'm bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagne. Let's talk about some legal options. If we work quickly, we can propose a plan to save your home, modify the loan, or in many cases even eliminate your second mortgage. The consultation is free. I've helped hundreds of people just like you make informed decisions about whether to save their home or exit it on a reasonable, organized timeline. The chapter you choose sets the tone for the next chapter of your life. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle. Wow, Robert Plant, for the first time in 16 years in public, performs Stairway to Heaven.
I mean, do you think he's doing it in private? Like he's just hanging out around the house and he's going, there's a way. I don't even know the lyrics, but.
If he does sing like that, I can see why he would only do it around the house.
He's on the crapper and he just sings it. That's when he gets it out.
He said he didn't want to do his old songs. He's always talked about that. And so you'd like, wow, I wonder what got him to do it. But this was a really good reason. It was a benefit for Cancer Awareness Trust, which was organized by Duran Duran's Andy Taylor. And I didn't know this, but Andy's been fighting stage 4 colon cancer.
I didn't know that either.
And so they must know each other, or at least Robert was tipped off about what we know the whole benefit and thought, okay, yeah, this is where I'm going to do Stairway to Heaven in public for the first time in 16 years.
There's a lady for sure, all that glitters is gold, and she's buying the stairway to heaven. When she gets there, she knows if the stores are all closed. With the work, she can't get what she came for. Ooh, and she's by Stairway to Heaven.
How old is he?
75, I believe.
75. So that had to be at least 50 years ago when he recorded that song.
Which is crazy.
Yeah.
The whole thing is just nuts because it's like it looks like a relatively smallish place that he's doing it in. I can't even imagine what it had to feel like if you're the backing band. All of a sudden, here you are playing like, you know, one of the most overplayed songs, but you get to do it with the guy.
Yeah.
Like that had to have been so intimidating. Like, here we go. We're doing Stairway to Heaven with Robert Plant. We better not F this up.
Yeah.
And they did a really good job of, I could tell, like, you know, there were certain parts in the song where I fast forward. I'm like, okay, let's see if he can pull this up. Because obviously he said it himself. He can't sing like he used to. And they toned down certain parts where it's like he's you know, like the recording, he's just nailing those vocals and it's super high. And in this, they bring everything down musically so that way vocally he doesn't get pushed.
Yeah.
Which was smart. I don't know, man. I think he could still pull it off. It's still good enough.
It's a great acoustic version. Like, I think that's what he can do is a cool acoustic version of that song. But you can tell with his voice, it's like, oh yeah, this is a guy 50 years older.
Yeah, he's not going to be able to wail those lines like he used to.
Yeah, but he's still, you know, within the parameters of his own voice, can still sing pretty good.
Now I know he's for years has said he doesn't like the song because of the lyrics. Like, that's nothing against the music. I don't think he's taking shots at his bandmates, but he's always like, I can't connect with those lyrics. And I was reading recently, I thought this was kind of interesting that the thing that got him back into liking the song were the Wilson sisters, Ann and Nancy from Heart.
Oh, yeah.
Because remember they did that performance of Stairway to Heaven. It was at the Kennedy Center Honors.
Yeah.
Forever ago. and they crushed it. And he was there with, I think, Jimmy Page, and they're both watching. I think it brought a tear to his eye. And I guess that was the moment where he fell back in love with the song.
Oh, that is awesome.
Which has got to feel so good if you're the Wilson sisters.
Yeah, they did kill it, though.
They were always doing great Zeppelin covers, and now all of a sudden you're the reason why he kind of likes one of his songs again.
Yeah, because people do get jaded, like you say, mm-hmm. and to all of a sudden go, wait, I helped you reconnect back with this tune. You're right. What a great honor, because they are, they are like legends within the rock and roll genre, which I'm sure the Wilson sisters looked up to when they were doing with
absolutely
theirs. Yeah, and wow. Yeah, all in all, a great thing. Unfortunately, it was still sad news about Andy
Hopefully
Taylor
he's gonna be
from
all right.
Duran Duran. I mean, stage four sounds serious.
Yeah.
So, wow. First time in 16 years that Robert Plant has performed Stairway to Heaven in public.
And if you're an old school Zeppelin fan, like, go back to the 80s, and they're like, oh, the reason why he's going to sing that song again is because of a guy from Duran Duran. You'd be like, oh, I don't believe that. Because they were so separate styles of music.
There's no way Robert Plant's a Duranimal. He's right. not going to do it.
You would never think Duran Duran's going to, and granted, obviously for reasons that are very powerful, but like no one ever thought maybe 20, 30 years ago, like Duran Duran's going to be the reason why Robert Plant sings that song again.
Yeah, that I wouldn't have taken that bet.
No.
Not at all. Hey, imagine this. Imagine coming back home from your vacation only to find your house was demolished. This did happen to one woman. Steve's going to tell you all about this. He's got the Migs report for you at 617 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
We all know cats are intelligent. Felix Cat Insurance was able to secretly record two cats on a hidden microphone. Let's listen in.
Did you hear the one about the three dogs at the park?
That's old, like four lives ago. But did you hear about the new pet insurance just for cats from felixcatinsurance.com?
Of course. What do I look like, a dog?
When you're coughing up a fur ball. Yes. Listen, Felix Cat Insurance plans start at under $1 per day and are as unique as you and me. They call it whisker-to-tail protection.
Even furballs?
Even that. Remember the last time you had a furball? I made a TikTok. It went viral.
Oh, well, that's good. Wait, you're on social media?
There you have it. Felix Cat Insurance. Customizable coverage exclusively for felines. Sorry, no dogs allowed. FelixCatInsurance.com. Get it? Meow. Insurance is underwritten by Independence American Insurance Company and produced by Independence Pet Group. Pre-existing conditions are not covered. For all terms and limitations, visit FelixCatInsurance.com/terms.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle.
If you're hearing an informative newscast right now, well, then you must not be listening to BJ and Migs. Live from the KISW News Center in downtown Seattle, this is the Migs Report.
Well, thanks, guys. Thanks to Palace Law for giving us the Migs Report. And today's a day to enjoy some bologna. I don't know when the last time you enjoyed a little bologna, BJ.
Oh, it really has been a while.
Yeah.
I mean, I had it all the time growing up because it was the cheap meat.
I used to love it as a kid.
Is it mortadella? Is that what mortadella is? Is it really bologna?
What, mozzadella?
Yeah.
Isn't that mozzarella?
No, that's mozzarella. Mortadella is, I think, is like a meat.
Mortadella.
Yeah, but
with
they
an
some sound like an old Italian woman.
You go mortadella. Yeah, give me some mortadella.
Whenever my mom would say that was mozzarella for her.
That was mozzarella.
She would say mutadella.
Was she really?
Yes. Oh,
so
my mom made up words.
So, Vicky, is it bologna? Is it better bologna?
It's their Italian version of bologna. I remember we served it when I worked at a restaurant. Yeah.
Yeah. Now that's bologna.
Well, you know what's good is this song.
Oh yeah.
It's this song.
Oh yeah. This is not good, buddy.
What?
You're not going to like this.
This is a great song.
I almost sang this as you said it was Bologna Day. So great minds, you're not going to like this at all that we're sharing the same mind.
Oh, man. Well, you got to. It's either that or the Oscar Mayer song.
Yeah, no.
My Bologna. A little more upbeat.
Weird Al's My Bologna sung to the Knack's My Sharona is a fantastic version.
Which is funny because it's My Bologna, really, is what it should be.
Yeah. My Bologna.
It's like there's a song on the new Blink-182 record, which was pissing me off because they were pronouncing turpentine wrong. How do they say it in the song, Danny? Do you remember?
Turpentine.
They keep saying turpentine, right? In the song,
it rhymes.
I'm like, right. So the whole song, I'm like, am I crazy or is the song, is the word turpentine, but they keep saying turpentine until the very end of the song when they correct themselves. I'm like, oh, thank you for giving me closure. Which is actually a pretty brilliant song now when I look back on it.
Sometimes you just got to rhyme for the rhyme. Because if I'm not mistaken, the Italian city or is Bologna.
Okay, yeah.
So it is Bologna. I mean, that's how we probably are supposed to say Bologna is Bologna, but we're, you know, we're Americans, and so we just mess up the pronunciations of everything.
Oh, man, it's also National Crazy Day, and I feel like we're all crazy having this conversation.
I want some mortadella.
But you know what's crazy is what happened in Georgia to this one woman. Her name's Susan. She went away on vacation. She came back to find out that a company called You Call It, We Haul It demolished a house that she owned.
What?
Fortunately, she wasn't living in that house at the time. I guess it was like a house that they owned, but nobody was living in. It's a property that's been like boarded up for a while, for like the last 15 years.
Oh.
But they did say, hey, we've been keeping the grounds maintained. We pay all the taxes. It wasn't abandoned. And it definitely, they did not want it to be torn down. The only reason why she found out that the house was torn down is a neighbor called her and said, hey, that house you have, it's gone now. And here's Susan talking about it.
Did you hire somebody to tear your house down next door to me that's been boarded up for about 15 years? And I said, no. She said, well, there's somebody over here just demolished the whole house and tore the whole house down. He told her to shut up and mind her own business. I said, well, look, I want to see a permit or something. And he said, okay. He pulls it out and he says, oh, I'm at the wrong address. And just packs everything up and leaves, and the house is deported, down, gone.
Yeah, this house isn't like, it's not like a little bit down. It's gone. It's, everything's torn up to shreds.
And he was at the wrong address and was like, whoops.
I love the old mind your own business. If somebody came up to you and said, hey, I think you're about to tear down the wrong house, wouldn't you like make sure those T's are crossed and those I's are dotted before you do it? I mean, just to, you know what? Let's just make sure.
Yeah, that this sounds like a reputable company.
You call it, we haul it.
Yeah, I feel like good old Jimmy over there was like, am I your old boy?
Well, the company, You Call It, We Haul It, they said that they're investigating how that happened and working to resolve the mishap. I mean, how do you resolve it other than build her a new house?
Yeah.
Which actually might be a bonus for her because it sounds like that house was just kind of boarded up.
Oh, yeah, now she's got all that extra cash to go do stuff.
Now, if only she knew of a company that can take that mess away.
Yeah, you know, let's
that
see.
Can haul that mess away.
I don't know.
She could just call a company.
Yeah. But would you call that company? If I was the neighbor of her, please don't call the same company. He's going to come wreck my house now.
Did you hear about the story that happened with this off-duty pilot that decided to try and turn off the engines of a plane as it was flying?
Yeah.
What the F?
This is not cool.
He was riding as a passenger in the cockpit of an Alaska Airlines flight, and he tried to turn off the engines of the plane. Thankfully, he was stopped and removed from the cockpit. In fact, here's the on-duty pilot calling air traffic control, and it just... Man, the level of calmness of this on-duty pilot. Like, I'd be cursing a lot talking about what just happened. But here he is explaining to air traffic control what just went down.
We've got the guy that tried to shut the engines down out of the cockpit. And he doesn't sound like he's causing any issue in the back right now. I think he's subdued. Other than that, we want law enforcement as soon as we get on the ground and park.
Other than that, we're doing all right over here. I'd be like, this mother effer just trying to turn off the mother effer.
I wonder, like, so he was sitting, so it was just the pilot and this dude.
Yeah.
How'd they subdue this guy? Unless they had a beefy flight attendant or something.
Or maybe that pilot just,
he's beefy.
Right. He took him down. That's crazy. Yeah, the dude's 44 years old. His name's Joseph. He's from California and he's up for attempted murder because, turn off that plane. That's exactly what would have happened.
So he's riding as a passenger, and they're like, well, you're a pilot. You can be up here. Why not? And he ends up being like whatever's going on in his head.
Right.
Wow.
It's bonkers. The whole thing is just bonkers.
Yeah, that's, oh, man. Well, I wonder if they're going to change policy and go, if you are not on duty, you are not allowed to ride up there.
Yeah, and they were going to San Francisco. They had to stop in Portland, Oregon because of all of this. And, he's been charged with 83 felony counts of attempted murder.
Well, I think he should
I don't think he's going to get to keep his job either.
No, and I hope that there's, like, basically massive mental evaluation and they keep him there for a while.
Yeah, and apparently pilots do occasionally ride the cockpit in the quote-unquote jump seat when traveling in an official capacity.
So there's a third seat that he...
I guess maybe like a pull-down seat or something like that.
Okay, because I always thought there was always a pilot co-pilot. I just assumed he was, like, taking the place of the co-pilot. Well, then maybe that... Then there was two people there, and maybe
they double-teamed him.
That's right.
All right, wow. Lighter news. That is just crazy, though.
Yeah,
do you tell... I mean, do you find out when you land? I mean, they're not going to tell, like, the passengers, like, hey, just so you know, that guy that we're subduing right now, he tried to turn the plane off.
It is weird, though, to go, like, if there's a big wrestling match and they're hauling them to the back of the plane.
People are going
to
want
to
know why.
Yeah, I'm like, what the hell's going on? There's nothing to be there. Over there, you see over there, it's a mount right there. And to the back, it's the guy who tried to turn the engine off. Okay, thank you for flying.
Insane. Exciting news for us Green Day fans. You might have just heard the brand new Green Day song, American Dream. American Dream is killing me. And they made a big announcement in Las Vegas. They did like a secret, not so secret show at the When We Were Young festival, which is like that pop punk emo festival. Your girl Avril Lavigne showed up there.
I know. I was so sad. I would have gone if I'd have known.
She looks so disinterested playing her own song. I got to be honest with you. It's so weird. Like, she looks like a robot up there.
Yeah, it is. You're right. Her live performances, I don't know if she's got issues. And it she's feels just like sick or tired or.
Every time it looks like she's performing against her will.
Yeah.
Like, someone has a gun to her head and said, get up on stage and sing Skater Boy.
I wish I could argue with you. But yeah, it's like, wow, you really. It's like she's 80.
What band did she go up there? All Time Low or was it Simple Plan?
I can't remember. All Time Low.
One of these bands.
Yep.
Hey, got it right.
Yeah.
All right, sweet. Yeah, which, I mean, must have been cool for them.
Oh, yeah.
They look like they were having the time of their life up there, and she just looks disinterested. Like she lost a bet.
Yeah.
I just thought that was her face.
That too.
Everything.
Everything she does, she always has that
language,
face.
Everything.
Yeah, I remember seeing, I don't know what's going on.
She's too cool for performing live anymore, guys.
Is that it?
Yeah, she's anti-perform.
Well, maybe she doesn't just
I want to stick up for her, but I cannot lie to you. It's really tough when someone looks like they're not having a fun time on stage.
At one point, it just looks like I should jump right now. Like, that's like how she looks like she's performing.
Yeah.
Well, anyways, Green Day, they were there. They also did like this cool show in Las Vegas. They played, I think, all of Dookie. Mm-hmm. And they made a very exciting announcement right here.
Okay, big announcement. We're doing a big tour next year. It's going to be Green Day, Smashing Pumpkins, Rancid, and Linda Mendez.
I like that one guy. Holy F word.
Yeah.
That big stadium tour is going to be happening. I don't know when it's going to happen here, but I think they're making that announcement next month when it comes to like all the tour dates. And they also, I saw it on their Apple Music, that the record is coming out. Is it January 12th or January 19th? Because on my Apple Music, it said the 12th.
Oh, interesting.
And I think, Danny, you mentioned it was on the 19th.
They posted on their social media that it was coming out the 19th. But
unless Apple Music gets a debut before anybody else.
Who knows? They got some time to figure that out. They got till January.
Because I could see that we're going to drop it for a week before on Apple Music before you can get it anywhere else. That might be a thing.
You're absolutely right. But it's exciting, and the song sounds great, so you'll probably hear it more because we played it this morning, and I'm sure you'll hear it more throughout the day.
Danny, yes or no on the song?
Oh, it's awesome.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's just weird hearing them sing a song where the word America's in it because I just think of American Idiot.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so when I hear it, like, the American Dream is, it's just, I don't know why, but my brain just kind of gets all a little screwy. It's too early in the morning.
You'll be okay.
I think I'm going to be all right.
You're going to be all right.
Thank you. I'm not going to turn off any planes, I tell you that much.
Thank God for that.
Oh, man, but the Texas Rangers turned off the playoff hopes for the Houston Astros yesterday.
Buddy.
Winning in Game 7, 11-4.
What a game.
So the Rangers are now going to the World Series. Who are they going to play? The winner of Game 7 between the Arizona Diamondbacks and the Philadelphia Phillies.
First time that both series have gone to Game 7 in a long time.
And how about this stat, which blew my mind when I saw this? First time since 2016 that the World Series will not feature the Houston Astros or the Los Angeles Dodgers.
Whoa, that is weird.
2016, we're 2023.
So, yeah, that's 7 years where it's always been one of those two teams.
That's bonkers.
I didn't realize that. That is nuts.
That's kind of crazy.
Yeah. And if I'm not mistaken, I think it's also going to be like wild card teams. Because I don't, because the Phillies didn't win their division, and neither did the Diamondbacks, and neither did the Rangers. So, yeah, it's going to be a wild card World Series.
Well, I'm rooting for whoever wins between the Diamondbacks and the Phillies. I don't want to see the Texas Rangers win the World Series.
Oh, really? This Adonis whatever Garcia kid is out of his mind. The guy is just a monster.
After what they did to the Mariners this season, yeah. I want to see them fail.
Yeah,
and fail miserably.
I can't swept. Blame you there.
I want the Philly fanatic just to beat them. Hey, 49ers got beat by the Vikings last night on Monday Night Football. That was awesome.
So, you know,
we're a half game out.
Yeah. You know, the kid's theory is coming true.
What kid is this?
This kid here tells you those first five games of the season, don't pay attention. In the real season, the Niners are 0-2.
They suck, man.
That's right, baby.
Man, what a game, man. The Vikings missed that field goal towards the end of the game. I'm like, this is going to bite them in the ass.
Yeah.
Because now you're giving the 49ers a chance to come back and win the game. And an interception, and the game is over. That was exciting, if you're not a 49ers fan, of course.
Yeah.
So they're with their 5-2 on the season. The Seahawks are 4-2 because, of course, it was a bye week. So that was awesome. The Seahawks ended up winning over the weekend, beating the Arizona Cardinals. Was it 20-10? We'll talk to Mitch from Mitch Unfiltered, Mitch Levy, at 7:47 just to see, should we be concerned about the offense? Are we okay? The defense is looking great, although they did take a little bit of a blow, or a big blow, with the Uchenna Nwosu. It looks like he's done for the season because of a pec injury.
Yeah.
Thankfully, Boyamafe has been playing really well, so that's at least a silver lining. Not that you want to see Nwosu be gone, because he's been a pretty good player for the Seahawks. The Kraken played tonight. They're taking on,
come on,
the Detroit Red Wings, who are currently on a five-game winning streak.
Well, yeah, but you know what?
You got to lose eventually.
Yeah, that's how I feel. God, I really thought after that first win that they were like on the comeback.
I was like, okay, now all these players are scoring.
Yeah.
This is the Kraken from last season. And then they play the Rangers. I mean, granted, half of the ice was dark, so I mean, maybe that hurt them. I don't know.
Did you see that? No, they
were having some light issues during the game.
Where they had to play through it?
Well, it was like, it was not dark, but it was darker than the other end of the ice, to the point where they had to like switch sides to make it fair for both teams.
Oh.
And the goalie for Jonathan Quick for the Rangers, he had a funny line saying something like, oh, I thought that was just them, like, you know, because they're a climate pledge arena, and their climate pledge is to save electricity.
That's a good line.
I thought it was pretty funny. Well, hopefully the Kraken win tonight. They're in Detroit, so that'll be nice for them to get their second win of the season. It's been a little bit of a rough start for our Seattle Kraken. Weather, 52 degrees, going to rain today, thanks to Beacon Plumbing. Heating, electrical, septic, and mechanical for giving us the Migs report, and that's what's up.
Yesterday, Steve, he did get this one wrong.
Who directed and starred in the comedy Tropic Thunder?
Oh, Seth Rogen.
No.
Robert Downey Jr.
No.
Sir.
Wow. Shush. Jack Black.
No.
Oh, yeah. Do you remember?
Ben Stiller.
There we go. Good job, buddy.
Booyah.
I knew you could do it a day later.
It only took me 24 hours.
You want a shot at beating Steve? You got it. 206-803-ROCK. We're playing Beat Migs. It's 647 on The Rock.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. Here's another question from a listener. If I can't afford to pay my bills, how am I going to afford attorneys and bankruptcy fees?
You know, one of the things people ask me all the time as a bankruptcy lawyer is that, how am I going to pay all these fees and costs, because I'm here because I can't afford to pay my bills? And of course, we understand that. I mean, being in the bankruptcy field. But, you know, one of the things to remember is that if you decide, once you make the decision to file bankruptcy, you can stop paying on all of the creditors that are going to be included in the bankruptcy. And those are the funds that you can use that you have been paying your creditors to pay your attorney fees and court costs to get your case filed. And once your case is filed, you're not going to have most of those payments anymore.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com. Thanks for listening.
This holiday season, make your journey memorable with Travel Centers of America, where our motto is simple. Return every traveler to the road better than they came. Avoid any hassle and stop at our one-stop shop for all your holiday travel needs. Fuel up, indulge in delicious snacks, and dine at one of our full-service restaurants. Hit the road with peace of mind knowing we've got you covered. For more info, go to ta-petro.com. Travel Centers of America, your road to happy travels.
From the very beginning, your kids mean everything to you. That means you do anything for them, especially if they're at risk. So when it comes to type 1 diabetes, screen it like you mean it. Because even if just one person in the family has it, your child is up to 15 times more likely to get it, too. Screen it like you mean it. Because type 1 diabetes can develop at any age. And once you get results, you can get prepared for your child's future. So screen it like you mean it. Type 1 starts long before there are symptoms. But one blood test could help you spot it early, before they need insulin, and could lower the risk of serious complications like diabetic ketoacidosis or DKA. Talk to your doctor about how to screen for type 1 diabetes, because the more you know, the more you can do. So don't wait. Tap now or visit screenfortype1.com to learn more. Again, that's screenfortype1.com. Screen it like you mean it.
Like any good agent, we're here for the open house, for the closing, for handing over keys. But because we're Realtors, we're here for so much more. Agents who are Realtors volunteer at nearly three times the national average. We're working to broaden access to credit, increase affordable housing supply, and ensure fair housing for all. And Realtors are bound by a code of ethics. We're here for it all. Realtors are members of the National Association of Realtors. That's who we are.
Transit is better with an Orca card. Here's why. One, it's easy. Just tap and pay your way onto Metro and all other public transit around the Sound. Two, your tap shows us when and where you're riding the most, so Metro can serve you better. And three, Orca cards are for everyone. 18 and younger now ride free with a free youth Orca card. So what are you waiting for? Get an Orca card. Tap for transit and make your ride count today. Visit kingcounty.gov/tap for transit.
Are you dealing with a personal injury? Don't go it alone. Turn to the experienced team at Phillips Law Firm. Their attorneys have helped thousands of clients get the compensation they deserve. Call Phillips Law Firm now. Call 1-800-JUSTICE or visit justiceforyou.com.
Looking to give the gift of pleasure? Add a little high heat to keep the desire burning. Or maybe you just need a little self-care. Come to Lovers for the best lingerie and toys to keep things hot this holiday. Save 20% on your purchase with Lovers Afterglow Rewards. Just mention LOVE20 at one of our 18 Western Washington locations. Offer valid with free Lovers Afterglow Rewards membership until November 30th. Some exclusions apply.
Your wages are being garnished. We can stop that now. It's hard enough to pay your bills when things are good, let alone when a big chunk of your take-home pay is gone before you even get your check. I'm bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagné, and I can stop the garnishment and get the creditors off your back immediately, often the same day as our consultation. Both Chapter 7 and 13 provide bankruptcy relief, but choosing the right chapter is crucial. In a free consultation, we can create a plan to get your finances back under your control. The chapter you choose sets the tone for the next chapter of your life. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle. Hope you got this on your calendars, man. Friday, November 17th, 7 p.m. Live day goes to prom night.
You don't have to do it during the morning this time, guys.
That's the good news.
You don't have to wake up early, take off from work, and just show up at 6 in the morning and start drinking. No! Come Friday night and, and hang out with all of us in the men's room. Ryan Castle, Taryn Daly, we'll all be having a great time.
It's still going to be live, by the way. We're going to broadcast it on KISW. All the sound effects, the music, special guests, everything will be done live. The music, all done live. And this year's theme is prom night, which means get dressed up. We will be awarding a prom king and a prom queen. How about that?
It's going to be awesome.
You want tickets? Well, join us at Snoqualmie Casino. Get those tickets at snocasino.com.
Let's play Beat Migs.
It's time to play the game. So everybody scream his name. Beat Migs. Don't be a loser. Whoa. Beat Migs. You're a loser.
Who's ready to beat Migs?
Yeah.
I know Adam from Covington is. Adam, are you there?
Hold on a second. Now he is.
Yes, ma'am.
Awesome. All right, Sue, now get out of here.
Goodbye.
For those playing at home, Adam has 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. You can pass all you want, but you'll only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
Yes.
McDonald's has a 23,000-pound sculpture in South Dakota of which of their food items?
McChicken?
No.
French fries?
No.
Pass.
Pennywise is a character from what movie?
It.
Yes. Yeah. The theory of relativity was created by who?
Edison?
No.
Da Vinci?
No.
Pass.
What East Coast state's official nickname is the Ocean State?
Maine?
No.
Pass.
Brian Hugh Warner is better known as what musician?
Pass.
What animal sleeps up to 22 hours each day?
Sloth?
No. That was painful.
So how did Adam do? Let's add that up.
One correct.
Woo! There we go.
Don't have to do much math for that.
Yeah. Can't believe he didn't know who my relative was. You know, who created the...
Okay.
It's true.
I still don't believe
it. You have to believe it. It's true.
I mean, it does make me look pretty smart, too.
It surely does, yeah. Silence!
Steve, are you ready?
Yes!
McDonald's has a 23,000-pound sculpture in South Dakota of which of their food items?
It's got to be the Big Mac.
It's not.
Oh. quarter pounder?
Yes.
There we go. Yeah,
Pennywise is a character from what movie? It. Yes. The theory of relativity was created by who?
Alfred Einstein.
No.
Isaac Newton.
No.
Albert Einstein.
There we go.
That's my relative you're talking
about
there.
What East Coast state's official nickname is the Ocean State?
I'm going to go with New Jersey.
No.
Florida?
No.
East Coast state is the Ocean State. I'm going to say New York.
No. Brian Hugh Warner is better known as what musician?
Who?
Brian Hugh Warner.
Brian Hugh Warner. I'm going to go with Rockwell.
No.
I don't know. Brian May?
No.
Somebody.
Chris Novoselic.
No. What animal sleeps up to 22 hours each day?
Ooh. Owl?
No.
Bat?
No.
Bear?
No. Gosh, this was so painful today. Yeah. But you got three correct, which is a win.
Oh, yeah. Great victory.
3-1.
Let's 3-1. It was a pitcher's duel almost. Adam, sorry about that, buddy.
No worries. Appreciate it.
Yeah, but it was a tough one. So I call again, Adam, and play, because this was not an easy set of questions.
I'm the best.
There you are.
Are you?
I am.
You're the best of those two.
That's all that matters.
Yeah. I love that you said Alfred or whatever you said.
Alfred E. Newman.
That's what I was about to say is Alfred E. Newman.
Yeah. But you didn't. East Coast State's official nickname, the Ocean State?
Gosh. It's not Massachusetts.
It's
That's
tiny.
The Bay State. Rhode Island?
Rhode Island.
Rhode Island's the Ocean State.
Yes.
Okay. I would have been going for New England states. I would have done that.
Brian Hugh Warner is better known as...
Marilyn Manson.
There we go!
Yeah,
just hit me.
Yeah, and as soon as you said it, I knew it. But I was like, I just couldn't think.
Yeah, I couldn't think about it while the game was going on.
Clearly.
Yeah. Okay, thanks.
And
thanks
what animal sleeps up to 22 hours each day?
Animal? A bear?
No.
Sloth?
Koala.
Dang it, that was my next one.
Yep.
Koalas? They're only awake for 2 hours?
Isn't that kind of amazing?
What a life.
Right?
That's a lot of pressure. You better make those 2 hours great.
They probably don't. They probably just eat.
Yeah.
And then go back to bed.
What's their, unless they really have great dreams, what's your lifespan if you've only got 2 hours a day? And if you live, 10 years? I don't know how long koalas live.
And how long do koalas live?
They probably, 20
years? 13 to 18 years.
Oh.
What kind of life is that if you only get 2 hours a day? I mean, that's like in a blink of an eye piece.
Yeah, you would think one of them would discover an energy drink and try and like get more crap done.
Yeah.
But you need sleep to survive, too. So.
22 hours of it?
I mean, you know, I know exactly what they're doing in those 2 hours.
Banging.
They're getting chlamydia.
Yeah.
Because there is a chlamydia epidemic amongst koalas.
Oh, you're right. So that's your life is you sleep and bang.
Yeah, you wake up with that morning, you know, excitement. And then you're like, I got only 2 hours to make this happen.
Yeah.
I'm going to just do it with whoever I can find.
Do you think they save time sometimes and do it with sleepy, like, female koalas?
You know, those aren't questions I've ever thought about coming up with answers for. I'm not sure.
I mean, because it's 22 hours. I mean, every once in a while, I mean, probably if I was a koala, I'd be like, look, I'm tired, but, you know, I know we got to do this to keep the people going. So go ahead.
Maybe like cuddle up on him and be like, yo, what are you up to? And like, clearly yeah, I'm sleeping. I mean, that's what I do here.
Yeah, come on. 22, man.
I feel like once one's awake, they just find another one that's awake. They're probably having sex with all of each other.
I figured out why they do sleep so much. It's because they have a very low energy diet because all they do is eat one thing and it doesn't really provide them much energy.
Well, if they stood awake and ate more, they'd be all right.
Right. They need to have a better diet.
Well, that would be interesting. I wonder, they must have done experiments where they give them stuff that more than their diet just to see if they and see if they stay up.
One texter says they're just perpetually stoned on eucalyptus leaves.
That's no, okay.
Yeah, it takes a lot of energy to break those leaves down, like, because they're technically toxic.
Oh,
maybe switch to a burger or something.
Right.
Let's get these kids,
get them a Big Mac.
Get them a Deluxe, man. Dick's Deluxe, that'll get them awake.
You know koalas are cute. People, if they're out there with like a little sign that says, give me a hamburger, someone's going to give them one.
Oh, they're not cute. They're vicious.
But they're cute looking.
They're kind of like gremlins.
Yeah, get them wet and they're creepy looking. Have you ever seen a wet koala?
That's
never.
I'm not hearing
No, I think you guys have not.
Yeah. Get on the internet more, Danny.
Damn, I feel
what does
like
a wet koala look like?
Oh, my gosh.
It doesn't.
Whoa.
Steve, why did you ask?
I don't know.
Wow, that's a gremlin-looking thing.
Yes.
Look at that. I thought you were kidding about the wet koala. Those things are insanity. No.
That looks like my neighbor's dog this weekend as it was coming at me.
Whoa.
I saw my Ring cam. Two dogs hanging on outside of my house. I'm just like, what the hell is going on? Our neighbors accidentally left their door in their back, like the goes into their backyard open. So their two dogs are just walking around the neighborhood. So I'm like, all right, you know what? I got to do them a solid, help them get the. So I was trying to get these dogs back, and they weren't listening to me. I had treats and all that. Finally, I ring the doorbell of the neighbors. I'm like, hey, your dogs are free. And they're like, oh, okay. The kid comes out, and this one little dog who's like wet from like playing around in the grass and all that looks just like a wet koala.
Oh, yeah,
and
yeah.
Starts going at me like
wow,
teeth are flaring. I think because it's trying to protect the little girl.
Oh, of course.
And the little girl's yelling at me. She's like, sir, just run. And I'm like, what? I'm like, no, I'm not gonna run. Like, don't tell me what to do.
Now the dog and the girl are both coming at you.
This girl is brighter than me. She just keeps going, sir, just run. Like, she's like, there's like, don't be too proud. Like, get the F away. This dog is. And then the other dog's bigger but looks more lovable, but that one's following it. Like, I'm going to kill him too. And I'm like, the one bites my shoe.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Thankfully doesn't get my foot. I'm like, trying, like, I'm like, do I kick this dog in front of this poor little kid?
Yes.
Like,
yeah.
Am I to blame? Because I didn't run. I didn't think I needed.
Yeah, you are. She told you to run, man.
Bro, I was like, actually legit scared. Like, I was like, this little crappy little dog is going to kill me.
Good thing you weren't wearing your sharks. And turn they bite your foot. Went bit right through those cheap knockoffs.
Yeah, dude. Bit right into the shoe, but got all the sole. And I'm like, my God, it's like a horror film.
Oh, yeah, dude. You don't mess with that.
But it looked exactly like that wet koala. Teeth are flying.
Dude, it is trippy.
Yes.
It is. Do you know if it was a male or female dog? You have any idea?
I think it was a female, but I'm not positive.
Because that happened to me this weekend.
Yeah, I think they called it by a name that sounded like a female type name. If I remember, I don't know.
Dude, it happened this weekend because we got that little puppy.
Yeah.
But I guess when male puppies don't get neutered yet, they get high like testosterone.
They just want to rip your head off.
And they're banging something for all day long, which is what this dog's been doing, or they want to rip your head off. So, you know, Kathy left the house. I was alone with the dog. Everything was fine. I put the dog in his little crate area so I could have a sandwich. Everything is fine. Then I go to the crate area and he trips out.
He's like, I got needs.
Dude. He was looking at me like we play all the time. He comes and wakes me up and everything. So there's never been a problem with him. He just was like that dog you talked about.
Oh, my God.
With the teeth out.
Yes.
I gave him a treat, and he took the treat from my hand and then tried to bite my hand after he got the treat first.
Yeah.
And he wouldn't come out. He was like tripping balls. So, when they're like that, I was like, okay, dude, I don't think I'm going to mess with you. I'm going to let you stay where you are. It was weird to see it, though.
When they start like, flaring that teeth, you're just like, oh my gosh, it's like a horror film.
And they don't care how big you are.
Oh no, this little one was ready to kill.
Yeah, and it's just like, do you realize I could just probably drop kick you? They don't care.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's just like, oh man. That's why when she told you to run, I'm laughing going, yeah, if it's a big dog, I'll run. If it's a little dog, you know what? No, I'm standing my ground.
That's kind of how I felt. As the dog's running, I'm like, sir, just run.
Some.
I'm like, no, I'm not going to run. I'm not letting this dog have dominance over me. And then I'm like, oh, crap, I should run.
Or you're going to scar a young child as you're kicking her dog across the street.
Yeah, that's exactly. I didn't want to kick the dog, but also I was like, dude.
Oh, man, dude.
Let me yell. Finally, the dog got distracted by the kid, and I just kind of briskly walked back through my garage.
Briskly. I did not run. I briskly walked.
I did not run. I just walked with intention.
I sped walk. It's different. Look it up.
I was walking with intention.
Hey, are you having problems at work, in your neighborhood with animals, or any other random problem where you need advice? Well, we're here for you. Call us, text us now, 206-803-ROCK. It's Help Wanted. We're going to do that at 717 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
We all know cats are intelligent. Felix Cat Insurance was able to secretly record two cats on a hidden microphone. Let's listen in.
Did you hear the one about the three dogs at the park?
That's old, like four lives ago. But did you hear about the new pet insurance just for cats from felixcatinsurance.com?
Of course. What do I look like, a dog?
When you're coughing up a furball. Yes. Listen, Felix Cat Insurance plans start at under $1 per day and are as unique as you and me. They call it whisker-to-tail protection.
Even furballs?
Even that. Remember the last time you had a furball? I made a TikTok. It went viral.
Oh, well, that's good. Wait, you're on social media?
There you have it. Felix Cat Insurance. Customizable coverage exclusively for felines. Sorry, no dogs allowed. FelixCatInsurance.com. Get it? Meow. Insurance is underwritten by Independence American Insurance Company and produced by Independence Pet Group. Pre-existing conditions are not covered. For all terms and limitations, visit FelixCatInsurance.com/terms.
Is your relationship going sideways?
Have a family issue? Problems with your coworker?
Do you need advice?
We're here to help. No problem is too dumb. No dilemma is too silly. This is Help Wanted with BJ and Migs.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. Lots of phone calls, lots of texts, lots of messages coming in from rockaholics, and they just go, man, I got issues. I need someone to help me out. Maybe you just need to vent. Could be relationships, work stuff, who knows? And if you think it's dumb, don't worry about it. That's our specialty.
Yes, that's about all we're good at, is dumb stuff.
We're here for you, 206-803-ROCK. It's Help Wanted.
All right, so we have a few that want some help. All one right. That involves a friend.
Yeah.
Another one involves some sexy time.
With a friend?
Possibly.
Okay.
And another one that involves Halloween.
Well, I mean, we're close to that holiday. I feel like if we don't do it now, we got to do it soon.
We do have the whole week, kind of. Right. But you're right.
Okay.
I mean, who do we want to put the pressure on?
Let's put the pressure on Danny.
Danny.
Halloween, of course.
I was kind of wanting Halloween. Yeah. So, all right.
You know what? Honestly, I don't even know if this one's going to take the entire segment. I feel like we can get through this one rather quickly. Maybe right. not. You never know how all this right. show
we'll
goes.
We'll let Vicky pick the next one then.
How's all right. That? Sounds good. My wife's mad at me because, well, I don't want to do a couple's costume with her this year.
Oh.
We've been married 10 years and we've done the couple's costume every year together. Honestly, I'm just tired of doing them. And this year I was thinking of going as a zombie cop because I thought it'd be fun and minimal effort since that's my actual job. But she wants to do an elaborate Barbie and Ken costume.
Oh, yeah.
I love the movie. I don't want to dress like Ken, though. Spend the money on something I'm only going to wear once. But she's insisting that we do it. I told her I wasn't going to participate, and now she's pissed. Should I just cave in and do what she wants, or should I stand my ground and do what I want this year? So he said his job, he wants to be a zombie cop because it's his job. Is he a zombie or is he a cop?
He's a zombie. Yeah, I mean, haven't you seen him? He's on The Walking Dead.
That would be funny if he was actually a cast member of The Walking Dead.
I do know what it's like to just, you know, what do you say, for 10 years they've been doing this?
10 years they've been doing this.
Dude, there was a time where it just, for me, I got tired of it. I got tired of having to get elaborate costumes every year. I just want to do something simple. And I wonder if it's more that than it's, you know, the idea it's a couples thing. Like, if it was a simple couples costume, I don't think you'd have a hard time with it. It's just the idea of like, oh, we got to go, is this whatever? Can I just do something simple that I can do right away? So I would think Ken is just simple. All you got to do is comb your hair and put like a, you can even get a tie-dye Knuff shirt, and you're in.
She's just really excited about being a zombie cop this year. Why can't she be like a zombie firefighter or something like that?
That would be that's also a happy medium.
Look, if you want to do a couple's costume, we're doing my theme.
Well, and it sounded like she had the costume. Like, it didn't sound like he was putting together the Ken costume. It sounds like she already had something ready for him to, like, buy.
Well, an elaborate Barbie and Ken costume is what he wrote.
If he doesn't have to go get it, what's elaborate about Ken? I'm a little confused by his, because I watched the movie. You don't have to do much to be Ken.
What if they're doing the one I've seen some people do it where they're in a box?
Oh, wow, that's so very elaborate.
Pretty elaborate.
Yeah. It just sounds like he doesn't want to be Ken.
Yeah.
Don't be Ken.
See, that really is, I think,
the issue.
And props
to you guys. If this is the biggest issue you have in your relationship, I think you guys are doing all right.
What about zombie Barbie and Ken?
Ooh. And Ken's a cop. I'm sure there's been a cop Ken in Barbie.
There has been
Barbie.
Cop Ken.
I mean, it's probably been cop Barbie. It's got to be a cop Ken.
See, zombie
cop Ken.
Barbie and Ken cops.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think we got it all figured out for you.
I mean, she's already got the Barbie outfits. Just, you know, to zombie her up.
It's that, or you just leave her.
Yeah, I think you should leave her.
Come back after Halloween, but just leave her for the time being. See, I'm the idiot, though, that does like doing the couple's costumes. I get excited about it. I don't even care what the couple costume is. Like, now with Tatum, now it's like, oh, man, I want to do a full-on family costume.
Yeah, it depends on who's going to make the call. Is she making the call?
Tatum, yes.
Yeah, so you're stuck with whatever she wants you to be.
She wants me to, well, here's the weird thing. When you put it in the court of a 3.5-year-old, almost 4-year-old, it's... like she wants to be Elsa, so she could be Elsa with her cousin, right? So I'm like, oh, do you want me to be? At first, you wanted me to be Olaf. And
the snowman.
I was like, okay, I could probably find like one of those dumb onesie Olaf costume things online. I was like, I'm in for that. And then she's like, no, I want you to actually be Rubble from Paw Patrol.
Wait, what?
And I'm like, well, what does that have to do with Elsa?
Yep.
It's just that
she's
what
like, what are you messing with my process? Pops?
Right. What, how dare you question me?
Yeah,
that doesn't change either, by the way.
I don't think it will.
No, because like when Lily was like younger, I could be the one that was like, hey, we're going to be Jack and Sally. And she was stoked on it. But then now it's like she wants to be a zombie witch thingy. And I'm like, okay, what do you want me to be? And she's like, I don't know, Dad. Popeye. You could be Max from Hocus Pocus, which is like a hat and a jacket. I'm like, all right, whatever.
I have to say, I don't think I ever got a costume design from my kids ever. Like, they got to be what they wanted to be, but they never asked us to be anything. I always did my own thing.
I'm shocked your daughter, Sarah, you should come in. I'm shocked she didn't force you to dress up a certain way.
Like, yeah.
She's, you know.
It wasn't
she's
in there.
Kind of high maintenance.
I don't remember any of us kids, though. Like, I don't remember any families that we would go trick-or-treating or, you know, ever dressing up like their kids or were we just a bad family, Sarah? I can't remember.
No, I probably was too focused on myself and my own costume and what I wanted to wear that I don't even think I knew if you guys were dressing up or not.
Yeah, I always dressed up, but I did what I wanted to do. And I remember that the parents of your friends, they got dressed up, but they did their own thing. It had nothing to do with what their kids were wearing. And Joey and Sarah, and I don't remember any kid ever complaining about that. I wonder if this is new with this new generation of kids that you have to like be all involved as a family. Because I don't remember anybody doing that. But Steve, you and Danny, like a lot of folks, definitely what they're doing.
I've seen for many years, I mean, at least 12, 15 years since I've been living in a home where people come trick-or-treating, that I see the parents dress similar to the kids.
Wow.
Maybe you just never bother to ask your child the question, man.
Yeah, listen, that's a fact. Because I didn't ask my children anything.
It's probably best, because I asked my little brother what he wanted me to be for Halloween. By the way, he wanted to be a hot dog. He said, hot dog. So we are both now hot dogs.
Oh, well.
If you had a dog, you get the dog hot dog costume, which I think is hilarious.
I need to borrow a dog.
Wow. Vicky, you have to show us you as a hot dog.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
He's excited.
A more important question, Sarah. So you guys, you and J-Rubs were Ken and Barbie. What if J-Rubs said, nah, not going to be Ken this year?
I'd be pissed.
For real?
Me too. I had a feeling.
Did you write this?
I know I can't be... I know it's unreasonable for me to be upset, but we go to a party every year, and there's contests, and every year I try to win couples costume. So I need a Ken to my Barbie this year.
Does it have to be your significant other, or could you have like a friend that could also be?
It could be someone else. Like, so then I would probably pull. Fine, I'll get someone else to be Ken.
Oh,
because I mean.
I don't know how I would react if my wife actually got mad at me because I didn't want to dress a certain way for Halloween. I'd be looking, I'd be like, I'll come back when you're normal.
let's say not mad. Let's just say disappointed.
You said pissed.
And then you'd be petty and holding a grudge. Let's be honest.
Yeah.
I mean, come on.
After a few cups of that box wine, you know you're going to be like yelling at him. You're not Ken.
A few Red Solo cups of it. Yeah, for sure.
One tonight.
You're so not Ken enough.
Right. I mean, it just put the costume on, especially if she got it already. Like, I was totally willing to buy J-Rubs his entire outfit for him. I'll pick it out. Just put it on. It's not that difficult.
That's fantastic. If you're willing to do that, I'll put on anything for the most part if you're going to pick it all out and save me the trouble.
Yeah. I was surprised because this party was a few weeks ago, and we did win couples costumes.
What do you win for that? Like, how much money?
Well, it was like my friend's Halloween party. So we won a gift card. We won a game board. A board game.
A board game. However you want to say it.
It was a lot of stuff, I will say. Uh-huh. It was pretty cool.
That's pretty good.
But, and then you just get the, we're couples costume winners. You know? Whatever. You guys don't go to parties. You don't know.
I mean, where do you brag about that? Like, do you put that on your Facebook? Because I haven't seen it on your Instagram.
You should be putting it on your Insta.
Did you see my Insta and our beautiful costumes? Obviously, just that picture. I should have won.
But I didn't see any mention of you being the couple's costume champions.
I should have. Okay.
You should update it.
I will.
Yeah.
I was actually surprised J-Rubs, too, wore the wig the entire time. Because I thought that was maybe going to be his... Oh, it's too tight on my head or it's too itchy. No, he rocked it the entire night.
The wig is good. I like the wig.
Yeah, look at him.
And there's so many different Kens in the movie that anybody can be Ken.
Anyone can.
Anybody.
How many other Ken and Barbies were at this party?
None.
That's actually a shocker. That's actually kind of shocking.
Yes. I was going to say, well, everyone's going to do that. No, so you were the only ones.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. See, if you're the only ones that show up, you're going to win just because of the movie.
But what happens if
there's multiple Kens and multiple Barbies?
Right. This weekend, it's probably going to be crazy because, I mean, this party was a few weekends ago, so I feel like people weren't really dressed to their best. But this weekend is actually like Halloween weekend. So.
See, we're not hitting any party. We're doing the Sumner Street of Treats. We did it last year, and it was amazing. So much fun. They just block off the streets of Sumner, like the main strip. And it's just a free-for-all of just walking around. All the businesses have candy. It's for the kids, but the adults get dressed up, too.
It's for the kids, for the candy, but we know who's getting the candy.
Well, I mean, you know, Dad's got to make sure there's no razor blades in any of them.
You got to check it.
In order to do that, you got to eat each one.
Really got to check it.
Well, that's easy. Everything is just right there.
Yeah, it's super fun.
Yeah.
But I didn't realize it's, like, right around the corner. I haven't even thought about ordering a costume.
Oh, well,
you haven't ordered yet?
How are you going to be rubble? What are you going to do?
I don't know.
Wow.
Amazon, I hope.
No,
maybe.
I just looked. They don't have any rubble adult costumes.
Oh,
they
boy.
They have Sky. They have the firefighter and the cop.
You better hop over to Spirit Halloween real quick.
Or wear the child something. One.
I've got like the stupid yellow hat we got at the Paw Patrol performance show.
All right.
Like the little plastic construction hat. I guess I could just put that on.
I hope that's enough because if it's not, and she looks at you and says, really, you're phoning this in, Pops?
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
She's going to let you know if she approves or not.
Yeah. This could ruin the entire night.
Most definitely.
Oh, man. Yeah. Because, you know, it's this no daddy. Is that the whole night going to be no daddy?
Yeah. What was the moment when your child started to hate you? The moment I forgot to dress up as Rubble from Paw Patrol.
I get it. Yeah. I'd be behind her on that.
Solidarity.
Tatum, I'm with you.
Right. I get her.
I
get the mindset of a 4-year-old.
Yep.
Well, we thought this would be quick, but apparently it was not.
Well, don't factor in your daughter and how she gets mad about things.
Yeah.
She's a very angry woman. It's
good thing poor husband.
I know. Yeah.
Did any of the prizes you guys got benefit him?
I mean, there was like a Baskin-Robbins gift card.
What was the gift card, too?
Baskin-Robbins.
That's fantastic.
Which is so random, but everybody loves some ice cream.
Yeah, but where is
that is random. Like, did someone find that on the street?
Where's there a Baskin-Robbins? They've closed them all, I thought.
I think we have one in Puyallup.
There's one in Issaquah still.
They closed the one on Mercer Island. They closed one at Bellevue Square, which, granted, that's east side. But, I mean, I don't know if there's any more or in east side.
It looks like there's one in Renton, one in Northgate.
All right,
this
Renton.
This says there's also another one in Bellevue.
There's another one in Bellevue?
It says it opens at 11.
Oh, all right. I didn't know Bellevue had two Baskin-Robbins.
Look at that. Doing today.
11,
yeah, 11 can't come soon enough, I tell you.
All right. 32 flavors. Let's go.
You're going to steal my gift card.
Yes, I am.
There we go. One Puyallup still.
Yeah.
A couple of them.
It's going to be a little bit of drive.
Okay, come, all right, Puyallup Bragger. I know. You guys got everything.
One on Main Avenue, one on Meridian.
We closed down our seats in the streets in Sumner. We got Puyallup.
Oh, you guys should come to Street of Treats. It's pretty awesome.
Okay, I'm going to drive all the way down there for a candy bar.
Well, I mean,
I could go to the store by my own and just pretend I'm going to give them to the kids.
It's about the spirit, man. Like, to walk around, everyone's got the costumes on.
The spirit, man, with your broke-ass rubble costume? What kind of spirit are you getting into?
Fair.
Hey, the Seahawks, they did win on Sunday, but should we be concerned about that damn offense? Well, we're going to catch up with the host of Mitch Unfiltered. Mitch Levy joins us at 7:47. On the Rock.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. He's here right now and has agreed to answer more of your questions about bankruptcy. How much does bankruptcy cost?
Usually with my office, we do a flat fee that includes all your court costs, filing fees, credit counseling, credit reports, and one cost. In Chapter 13 cases, that usually starts at about $900. With Chapter 7 cases, the total costs, including all your court costs, attorney fees, is usually about $1,500. We offer payment plans on Chapter 7, so you can start a file with my office for as little as $200. You can send your creditor calls to us. We'll take your creditor calls while you gather up your information and make payments on the rest of the fees. With Chapter 13 cases, we can make payment arrangements in most cases as well and get your case filed even sooner in a Chapter 13 case because of the reorganization aspect to it.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com. Thanks for listening.
This holiday season, make your journey memorable with Travel Centers of America, where our motto is simple. Return every traveler to the road better than they came. Avoid any hassle and stop at our one-stop shop for all your holiday travel needs. Fuel up, indulge in delicious snacks, and dine at one of our full-service restaurants. Hit the road with peace of mind knowing we've got you covered. For more info, go to ta-petro.com. Travel Centers of America, your road to happy travels.
From the very beginning, your kids mean everything to you. That means you do anything for them, especially if they're at risk. So when it comes to type 1 diabetes, screen it like you mean it. Because even if just one person in the family has it, your child is up to 15 times more likely to get it, too. Screen it like you mean it. Because type 1 diabetes can develop at any age. And once you get results, you can get prepared for your child's future. So screen it like you mean it. Type 1 starts long before there are symptoms. But one blood test could help you spot it early, before they need insulin, and could lower the risk of serious complications like diabetic ketoacidosis or DKA. Talk to your doctor about how to screen for type 1 diabetes. Because the more you know, the more you can do. So don't wait. Tap now or visit screenfortype1.com to learn more. Again, that's screenfortype1.com. Screen it like you mean it.
Are you feeling pressure to choose an insurance plan that doesn't fit your family? You're not alone. This open enrollment, take back freedom over your healthcare decisions with Christian Healthcare Ministries. CHM is the faith-based alternative to insurance that aligns with the values that matter most. Choose a provider you trust with no network restrictions and affordable healthcare programs that work for you. Enroll today at chministries.org/solution. That's chministries.org/solution.
Transit is better with an Orca card. Here's why. One, it's easy. Just tap and pay your way onto Metro and all other public transit around the Sound. Two, your tap shows us when and where you're riding the most, so Metro can serve you better. And three, Orca cards are for everyone. 18 and younger now ride free with a free youth Orca card. So what are you waiting for? Get an Orca card, tap for transit, and make your ride count today. Visit kingcounty.gov/tap for transit.
Have you been in an accident that wasn't your fault? Feeling overwhelmed and unsure what to do next? Look no further. The personal injury attorneys at Phillips Law Firm are here to help. Phillips Law Firm understands that accidents can turn your life upside down. That's why they're dedicated to fighting for the compensation you deserve and to making the process as stress-free as possible. Don't wait any longer. Call now, 1-800-JUSTICE, or visit justiceforyou.com.
Looking to give the gift of pleasure? Add a little high heat to keep the desire burning.
Or maybe you just need a little self-care. Come to Lovers for the best lingerie and toys to keep things hot this holiday. Save 20% on your purchase with Lovers Afterglow Rewards. Just mention LOVE20 at one of our 18 Western Washington locations. Offer valid with free Lovers Afterglow Rewards membership until November 30th. Some exclusions apply.
Your driver's license is important so you can get back and forth to work, get your kids to school, and back and forth to daycare. If your license has been suspended because you can't pay your tickets, you can't do any of those things. Let's talk about Chapter 13 bankruptcy. You may have heard that tickets cannot be discharged, but they can be dealt with in a Chapter 13 case. Why not come in for a free consultation? The chapter you choose will make all the difference to your getting back, legally, on the road. Let's design a plan to pay off your tickets and restore your license immediately. I'm attorney Travis Gagne. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle.
BJ, it's always great to have our next guest on. Yes, a day late, but that doesn't matter because, well, the Seahawks won this weekend, and it's always awesome to talk to our friend, the host of Mitch Unfiltered, Mitch Levy.
There he is.
Help wanted. Help wanted.
Yeah?
What are you dressing as for Halloween?
Yeah. What do you need?
Well, this is part of the problem, folks. I need some help. Can you guys advise me, please?
Yes.
Yeah.
Here's the problem. I used to think that I was in the know pop culture-wise, but when Saturday Night Live starts having guest hosts on that I've never heard of...
I'm feeling way...
Who in the hell is Bad Bunny? Can somebody please explain to me who Bad Bunny is, please? Do you guys know? Are you hip?
He's one of the biggest music artists right now, and it's insane, dude. Yeah, because
he
showed up in the world of wrestling because he's a big wrestling fan. He's actually wrestled a couple times at WrestleMania and stuff like that, and the entire wrestling fan base, I think, that doesn't speak Spanish, were like, who the hell is Bad Bunny? And then you find out globally he's a massive star.
Now, what I liked most about your explanation as to who he was BJ threw in a little yeah in there. Now, I want to know... give me a song or two, BJ.
I don't have any idea about his songs, but like Steve said, I know who he is. Yeah, I do know who he is. And I actually thought he did a good job on SNL, considering he and Pedro Pascal playing an aunt and a Hispanic mother and a Hispanic aunt. It was really one of the funniest segments I've had in a long time on SNL. So, but yeah, musically, I couldn't tell you a single damn song he sings.
Well, because none of them are in English.
When he was introduced on Saturday Night Live, that was the first time I had ever heard the words Bad Bunny.
I've never heard of the guy, for God's sake. I only heard about him 6 months ago.
In all fairness, Mitch, like I can't give you too hard of a time because it was a couple of years ago and I was like, who's Bad Bunny and why is he selling out the Tacoma Dome or the Climate, like whatever the arena was? Like, he sells out arenas left and right, man. It's insane.
And like, I tried to watch one of his songs on SNL, Mitch, and like Steve said, it was in Spanish. I'm going, all right, I don't know what, I have no idea what's happening here.
Dude, a lot of times I'm watching, I'm like, I don't know what he's singing, but I kind of like the song. Like, I know, he could be singing a song about how much he hates Steve. And I'm
What I said to my partner on episode 259, which has been out for days now.
Days.
What I said to Hotshot on 259 was that... I gave up wanting to know who the musical act, like being familiar with the musical act on Saturday Night Live. I gave that up like when I was 17 years old. I haven't known the musical act on Saturday Night Live since I was 17, about 40 years ago.
Yeah.
But I did not. I'm not giving up like the overall host to the show so soon. It's just ridiculous how 2 out of every 3 weeks that show trots somebody out who's supposed to be big and famous that I have absolutely never heard of.
So. Welcome to the Get Off My Lawn crowd, pal.
Right?
It's good to have you on. It's good to have you on the porch.
Bad Mitchie
help
over
wanted.
Here.
Help one.
But
I can tell you about the Seahawks.
Okay, we're worried, Mitch. We're worried over here.
Okay.
Yeah, we're a little worried.
I had a feeling. I am endlessly intrigued by this team.
Okay.
This is the most interesting Seahawks team, and I don't think you should be worried at all.
Wow.
I think this is the most interesting Seahawks team since about 20, I'm not great with years and teams. I would say 2015, 2016, 2017, somewhere in there.
the end of the Legion of Boom.
Yeah.
This, to me, is a very interesting and very easy to talk about team that's different than all the teams they've had in the last many years. I don't know what to think, but it's interesting. They're 4-2. Yeah, did they struggle with the Cardinals a little bit? Yeah. Are the Cardinals a bad team? Yeah. But there's something going on. We talked about this the last 2 weeks. There is something going on with this defense that we haven't seen in years in Seattle. Do you know that they held the Cardinals under 250 total yards on Sunday, which means they've held the last three straight opponents under 250 total yards? The Seattle Seahawks have not done that, holding three teams in a row to under 250 since the 2015 season. It's 8 years since they've done that.
Okay, that may, maybe that's the season you're thinking about then, that 2015 season that's got you intrigued.
Well, I just think it's been so long since we had here in Seattle a defense that goes out on the field that you have a lot of confidence in. And week by week, I'm being convinced. Now, I'm a little bit of a skeptic. Opponents 1-3 were the Giants and the Cardinals.
Mm-hmm.
The one in the middle were the Bengals. I still want to see it a little bit more, but it really feels like something is percolating defensively in Seattle. And if that's the case, to me, and I'm just one person, a Seahawks team that's the last few years that is okay offensively but terrible on defense, okay offensively, terrible on defense, good offensively, terrible on defense. You flip that around, good on defense, okay on offense, and it becomes a much more interesting team to me about what they could accomplish this season and in the next couple of seasons than the other way around. So I am not worried. I am very interested to see what's going to happen and excited to see what's going to happen.
Me too. I'm fired up. I think of that whole offensive line figured out. I mean, I think Bad Bunny played a center this last game. It'd be nice to get the actual set group, but I mean, I'm fired up, man. It's fun to see this defense playing so well. Jamal Adams.
Really good.
Yeah.
Really good.
It's so nice that he's not injured.
Devin Witherspoon playing great. Trey Brown playing great. Reek Woolen coming. The linebackers, Jordan Brooks played an astounding game the other day. And I just think all of these guys are feeding up. Now, I will say to your audience and to you guys that this loss of Nwosu for the season that we just found out yesterday is a killer.
Yep.
Because there's a huge drop-off from Chenna Nwosu to Daryl Taylor, whoever is next up on that side. He was their best defensive player last year, their number one defensive player last year. So to lose him for the year is a real step back and a real bummer. But I just, you know, I've been thinking about it for the last 48 hours and thinking about if they are really, really good defensively, and in the last 3 weeks they have been top-notch, grade-A defense. If they are really, really good defensively, I'll go back to what Migsy just said. You can explain a little bit the offense. I mean, you can talk about the offensive line. DK Metcalf didn't play the other day. They haven't played with a healthy offensive line in a month and a half. And they're going to get healthy one of these days. So I think it's interesting. I think there's a chance they could be. We watched the Niners lose last night to the Vikings. I just think a team like the Seahawks, a team that's built like the Seahawks are this year, will give the 49ers more of a run in those two games than they would if they were flip-flopped where the offense was okay or good and the defense was terrible and couldn't stop Christian McCaffrey. So
yeah, this is going to be very interesting because, as you know, with my theory, the Niners are not looking good now that the regular season has started with my theory. I mean, they're 0-2 after the first five games, which we might be seeing close to what the Niners might be, whereas in the beginning, when people are just trying to figure it out and they have not played a lot of regular season or any action at all, you go 5-0, okay, but were you playing teams when they were really up to speed and they really were in rhythm and they really were like, you know, basically ready to go? This is exciting now to go, all right, the Niners might not be as fantastic as we thought they were, and like you said, Mitch, our defense is definitely getting better as opposed to what it was in the first three, four games of the season. And that could be an exciting thing to go, if we're better than we think and the Niners are not as good as we think, you're right. These could be very competitive games.
Yeah, I think I'm more interested in the fact that it's just been a long time since the Seahawks have had a good defense.
Yeah.
And, I mean, it's years and years and years. And these guys, the way number 21 is playing, and I was one of the guys who was worried about Devin Witherspoon and the selection of Witherspoon and Jalen Carter in Philadelphia, and I was like, this guy can't even get on the field during the exhibition year, and he's always hurt, and when he's out there, he's getting burned by the wide receivers of the Seahawks. I was really concerned as we walked our way through the preseason, but everything you see from number 21, the new fifth overall pick, whatever it was, of the Seahawks, he looks all pro quality.
Dude, that hit was awesome.
All pro quality. Yeah. He is not just covering. He's coming up on blitzes. He's sacking the quarterback. He's making big hits in the flat, in the passing game, in the running game. And then when you combine him with Tariq Woolen, now called Reek Woolen, who was a skosh away from being the defensive rookie of the year last year. On the other side, when you have two young, super young, special corners in 2023 that can take receivers out of games, you really have something. And they might have something here. And it frees up linebackers like Bobby Wagner and like the aforementioned Jordan Brooks to run around and just make plays. It frees up safeties. It just changes. When you have two corners that don't need a lot of help, I guess is what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. When you got, it's 2023, wide receivers are running around making plays. They're catching 110 balls. They're, passing games are passing for 5,000 yards in even mediocre NFL cities. When you've got corners that can take receivers out without needing over-the-top help and double coverage, and you free those safeties and linebackers up to make other plays, now you are on to something really special. And I just think Devin Witherspoon has changed everything for the Seahawks, has changed the trajectory of the Seahawks defense, which has changed the trajectory of the team. And going back to your point, BJ, look where they are. They're 4-2.
Yeah.
After six games. Have they been an impressive 4-2? No. Did they look good the first three games when they were giving up 300 yards to Andy Dalton? No. But they're 4-2. The Niners are 5-2.
Yeah.
The Seahawks, as you know, one of their two losses to an AFC team doesn't hurt. We talked about this a couple of weeks ago or last week about the Bengals game. If you're going to lose a game, lose a road game to the AFC in terms of playoff tiebreaker. So they're 4-2. And when you look at the NFC, and I know this has been a constant theme of our conversations the last few weeks, look at the NFC.
Yeah.
Okay, Philadelphia's good.
Yep.
You're not convinced on San Francisco. I think San Francisco's really, really good despite their two losses the last couple of weeks. But after that, everybody's been screaming at me on the podcast, Mitch, why do you keep asking who the third best team is in the conference? Why do you keep asking who the third best team in the conference? Detroit is the third best team in the conference. You're 5-1. People have been yelling at me about Detroit, who, by the way, was down 35-0 before the national anthem finished the other day in Baltimore. Okay. That's the third best team in the NFC. So, and, oh, by the way, who did they lose to in week two of the season at home?
Wait, give me some time.
In their home opener. That would be the Seattle Seahawks.
All right, that was us.
I don't see where. Are the Cowboys good? Yeah, some weeks they're good. Some weeks they're a disaster. I don't see where the Seahawks can't reasonably, over the next 8-10 weeks, solidify their spot as one of, let's just say conservatively, the four best teams in the NFC.
Yeah, I think they've got to beat the Rams when they play them again. Of course, got to beat the Cardinals. And I think they've got to at least split with the Niners for you to be right about that.
Why do they have to split with the Niners for me to be right about them being one of the four best teams in the NFC?
Because I think if they don't beat the Rams and they don't split with the Niners, I think they're not one of the four best. I think that they have to, they're going to have, or at least play close games with the Niners. And you got to beat the Rams. Otherwise, I just don't think they're the fourth best. I don't think they're one of the four best teams in the NFC if they can't beat the Rams. You got to.
Well, I tend to look at the teams that are in front of them. They're going to play a Cleveland team this Sunday.
Which is, you know, I don't know how that's going to go.
It's vintage jersey day, man. It's going to go with a big W.
It's going to be, I don't know how it's going to go either. I know it's going to look great because they're going to be in those retro jerseys.
Yeah, that's
the first time ever
they're
going to be in those retro jerseys. But yeah, you get a Cleveland team that beat the 49ers 2 weeks ago, the team you're talking about. You get a Cleveland team that defensively is being touted as the best defensive team in the National Football League, led by Myles Garrett. You unfortunately are going to go into that game if you're the Seahawks. Still with backup left tackle, at least one backup left tackle, and Myles Garrett, you don't want to face Myles Garrett with a backup. There are going to be complications to Sunday, but they come here, and they come here with an offense that's really struggling. Deshaun Watson's got a bad shoulder. They've got P.J. Walker as their backup quarterback. Again, you've got a defense that's surging right now. There's no reason that on Sunday the Seahawks defense doesn't rule the day again against a very questionable offensive team in the Browns. So
we'll see what happens. And I also think it could be a tale of turnovers, which that's what scares me about such a good defense and the fact that Geno and the boys have been turning it over because, you know, the Browns are a better team than the Cardinals. The Cardinals did not capitalize really at all on those turnovers.
Hopefully we have our center next. You know, that will work out better. That fumble, I think, was fully just Geno's fault.
Yeah, that will definitely help. And I'm a little worried, like you said, because that damn defense of Cleveland.
Well, there's no debating. The Seahawks offense is struggling. There's no question that in the red zone they're having trouble punching the ball in the end zone. Look, they had first and goal from inside the 1 yard line, did they not, the other day? First and goal from inside the one, and three plays later, it's fourth and goal from the 2.5 or the 3, and you got to kick a field goal. Then you come down the next possession and you throw that interception on the left sideline.
Yeah.
Then you come down the next possession and you fumble. So that's three possessions in a row where you could have blown the game. We could be talking about a 30-10 game here very, very easily. But the Seahawks offense is struggling. Again, I'll go back to the original point. I think it's more interesting with the Seahawks offense and a makeshift offensive line, no DK Metcalf. I still think it's much more interesting product with the Seahawks offense struggling.
I like the
than
optimism.
The Seahawks defense, because I can see the offense. I mean, the first 9 weeks of the season last year, Migsy, there weren't five teams better offensively than the Seattle Seahawks, and they have since added a wide receiver who's good, a good young wide receiver. They've added some new offensive linemen who unfortunately haven't been able to play, but they will. There's reason to believe, I'm not saying that in 4 weeks they're going to have the best offense in the NFL, but there's reason to believe that they will get it together offensively. And if they do, and this defense is, there's a lot of ifs, but if they do.
Boom, 13-4 season like me.
And the Seahawks offense and the Seahawks defense is real, they're going to give a lot of people
If it ends up being a 13-4 season, I might
hear the end of that.
I really might have to just quit radio. I might have to. If it ends up being that way.
Yeah. Well, I think we'd all like to see. I'm not going to say both of those things.
We'd all like to see. Where you're saying is both people like to see me quit radio. You're right. They don't want to see
I'll
both
have
of
those. I'm
says not going to define what they want to see.
All right. Just well,
say, I'll make a hat episode, that says 13-4 on it. I'll show up every day rubbing that in.
Episode 259 is out as we speak. Wherever you listen to podcasts, MitchUnfiltered.com is where you go. Mitch, always good. I hope. I say you can tell me, I told you so, this coming, next time we talk to you, man, because that would be fantastic if they beat Cleveland. It will be great.
The Seahawks will be 5-2 after the game against Cleveland on Sunday.
Wow, he's calling it.
I love it.
I'm calling it.
Should I bet breakfast?
Yes.
You're willing to bet breakfast?
Are you just looking to bet against the Seahawks? Why would you bet against the Seahawks?
Because that's when
What's
the teams
wrong?
Win.
What's the matter
when
with
I
you?
Bet you, when I bet against you, our team wins. I have to buy breakfast. It's a really good superstition that I have.
I'm all for it because win, lose, I get food.
Listen, I'm not going to bet you if you don't want to, but you know your track record with me is that every time I bet you, you win.
No, you won the last one, didn't you? You said you won
well,
the last
one. Well, I think that was a baseball bet.
That was Mariners. That doesn't
count. That was a Mariners bet. When it's the Seahawks, you always beat me in the bet. Mariners, well, you don't know anything about baseball. That's why you lose
those
bets.
Stop it. Stop it. They will be 5-2. No bet. Right. They'll be 5-2
all right,
after
then.
The Cleveland game. Okay.
Sounds like a plan. Mitch, okay. unfiltered.com. Wherever you get podcasts, get episode 259. Mitch, we'll talk to you soon, buddy.
Thank
all right.
You.
Hey, I was just on a plane yesterday, but luckily this woman wasn't on my plane because she got kicked off all for because she was petting her dog. You're going to hear what happened.
Is that a euphemism?
Yeah, you know what it could be. You'll hear all about this woman petting her dog or something at 8:20 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
We all know cats are intelligent. Felix Cat Insurance was able to secretly record two cats on a hidden microphone. Let's listen in.
Did you hear the one about the three dogs at the park?
That's old. Like four lives ago. But did you hear about the new pet insurance just for cats from FelixCatInsurance.com?
Of course. What do I look like, a dog?
When you're coughing up a furball. Yes. Listen, Felix Cat Insurance plans start at under $1 per day and are as unique as you and me. They call it whisker-to-tail protection.
Even furballs?
Even that. Remember the last time you had a furball? I made a TikTok. It went viral.
Oh, well, that's good. Wait, you're on social media?
There you have it. Felix Cat Insurance. Customizable coverage exclusively for felines. Sorry, no dogs allowed. FelixCatInsurance.com. Get it? Meow. Insurance is underwritten by Independence American Insurance Company and produced by Independence Pet Group. Pre-existing conditions are not covered. For all terms and limitations, visit FelixCatInsurance.com/terms.
This holiday season, make your journey memorable with Travel Centers of America. Visit our one-stop shop for all your holiday travel needs. Fuel up, get snacks, and dine at one of our full-service restaurants. Hit the road with peace of mind knowing we've got you covered. Travel Centers of America.
These days, every new potential hire can feel like a high-stakes wager for your small business. You want to be 100% certain that you have access to the best qualified candidates available. That's why you have to check out LinkedIn Jobs. LinkedIn Jobs help find the right people for your team faster and for free. Post your job for free at linkedin.com/decide. That's linkedin.com/decide to post your job for free. Terms and conditions apply.
Transit is better with an Orca card. Here's why. One, it's easy. Just tap and pay your way onto Metro and all other public transit around the Sound. Two, your tap shows us when and where you're riding the most, so Metro can serve you better. And three, Orca cards are for everyone. 18 and younger now ride free with a free youth Orca card. So what are you waiting for? Get an Orca card, tap for transit, and make your ride count today. Visit kingcounty.gov/tap for transit.
KISW, The Rock of Seattle. You can check out this video on the BJ and Migs page of KISW.com. It's a woman on a Southwest flight, and she's getting spread around because she was kicked off the plane because she was petting her dog after being told not to pet her dog.
Yeah, I guess she's, from what I was reading, I read the person who posted the video, they gave like a whole blurb about it, and apparently like they were just, this woman was going to get the dog in California, like she got it, and it's a puppy. It's like 8 weeks old, and then was going to fly back home with the puppy. So she flew out probably to get the puppy, and I guess the puppy was whining a little bit. So she put her hand in the crate and was like, "Hey, calm down." The puppy stopped whining, and then the flight attendant was like, "No, you can't unzip the carrier."
Oh,
and she's like, "Okay," so she zipped it back up, but then started petting the puppy outside of the carrier on the mesh.
Okay,
and I guess that was an issue because then the crate was still. It was supposed to go under her, under the seat.
Oh, right. Not supposed to be on your
but
lap.
But she's like, I'm just trying to keep it calm before we take off. Which, yeah. I mean, I think, you know, there's, I understand there's rules, but sometimes, you can be like, okay, well, once we get flying, get that puppy under the seat. I understand that you're trying to keep it from whining the whole time.
Yeah, they do. They get real tough about the rules, and I don't know who to be mad at on this, but here's audio of the woman getting off the plane.
No, I'm not going to have you touch a thing of mine. You are rude, you are a mean person, and I will never fly Southwest again. Unbelievable. Come on, baby girl.
We wish you the best of luck,
honey. Thank you.
I'm sorry.
This is ridiculous.
Oh, it's insane. It's insane.
It's not like you even had the dog out. You had it where you were petting it.
No,
be ashamed of yourself.
I love the passenger. Yeah. Like, you should be ashamed of yourself.
Good for the passenger. Like, you know, hey. So I gather the plane hadn't taken off. That was the idea, is that you, because they really, right. If you have a laptop, I think it's really funny because yesterday that happened to me. I have my iPad on my lap and I'm watching a show as right. We're about to take off. They tell the person who's got a laptop on their lap, put that away yeah. And say nothing to me. And I'm kind of like, that is kind of odd. Can't my iPad fly out of my hands and hurt somebody too?
It is strange. I mean, yeah, you think, okay, can we just let this person do this so the puppy doesn't whine? Or can we let this person have their laptop on their lap?
You know, and that's why it's so bizarre with the rules. I don't know what to say. I feel bad for the flight attendants because they're obviously told they got to do this. They don't make the rules.
I think there's an agenda because I was reading about this story.
Oh, really?
I think there's an anti-dog agenda because apparently because it's Halloween season, so sometimes I guess people dress up. And one of the flight attendants, oddly enough, was dressed up as a cat.
Oh!
And apparently went over to the woman and said, are we going to have a problem here?
As a cat? Dressed up as a cat? Are we going to have a problem with your dog? Come on.
I'm not making
That's
this
how
up.
That happened?
The attendant, dressed as a cat, came okay. over and said, quote, are we going to have a problem here?
That's fantastic. Now I
can't find any pictures or video of the woman dressed as a cat, though. They just have the dude who's not dressed as anything other than a douche.
Now, now Southwest definitely is different when, you know, they do their jokes and they're very casual, it seems, how they do a lot mm-hmm. of things. So that does seem like a very, really snarky and very snippy response if they were serious. But you're dressed as a cat. Am I supposed to take you seriously as you're dressed up?
I would have a very hard time not laughing. I'm like, oh,
yeah, I would
cat
think it was a
has
joke.
An issue with the dog.
Yeah, I wouldn't expect next thing you know I'm getting like, hey, get the hell off the plane.
Right, here's some yarn. Run away, flight attendant.
You know, and I look, not that I am a dog person, because I'm really not.
You?
But I know. But I do know that the plane vibrations and everything, they're hard for dogs.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not flying for a dog is really, really challenging. I felt so bad, even for the dog I hated, that we'd fly back and forth, because I knew that dog was tripping balls. Because, I mean, apparently dogs really, like, when they're on the ground, they really can, like, they have some sort of biorhythmic whatever connection to the earth that helps them keep balanced. Like, stuff that we don't even know that they got going on. Now you're putting them like 10,000 feet up in the air, and of course if they can't feel that connection that's naturally part of their body rhythm, I can understand why they're just like, holy crap, what is going on?
One texter says maybe this woman needs to not torture the puppy and leave it at home, but she was, I think, going to get the puppy
that
to bring
yeah
home.
They that's
I mean,
what happened.
There's an argument. You could go drive, I guess.
And if you put them like in storage or like in a part where you like the pet area of the plane itself, there is a place.
Yeah,
I hear that's also horrible for, like, there's no way to get this done, to get a dog to you by plane without really the dog going through hell.
Do you have to pay extra, though, to carry a pet onto the, like, I have no idea. I've never traveled with a pet, so
I don't know now.
I don't know how it works.
But before, I don't think we, I think we
charge
did.
For everything now.
Yeah, I think we had to pay a little bit of something.
I want to say on Southwest, there's like a $75 fee.
Okay.
I believe.
Even though they're the carry-on. Like, yeah. They don't take up a seat. I often get pissed at the charge, as it were, and, you know, and thinking, like, wait a minute. What, it's like paying for an infant or whatever, but, you know, they're not sitting in a seat because they're right with you. I don't know.
When you make I don't know how it is if you get fired for this, but if I was, like, a flight attendant and I saw, like, okay, this puppy's whining, but if the lady puts her hand next to the puppy, even through the mesh, and doesn't even open up the zipper, the puppy stops whining, I'd be like, all right, when we get flying, you got to put the puppy on, you know. Yeah, I almost feel like there's like a little bit of like you could bend the rules a little bit.
Yeah, I
but who am I? I'm not a good.
Yeah,
fighter.
I know it. That's why it's a little challenging for me to understand the situation. I know they don't like to, like I said, but I get to have my laptop, my iPad out.
It is funny.
So it's like, I don't, you know, I mean, I guess the dog bag could fly if there was turbulence and hit somebody in the head. I think that's the whole idea.
According to Southwest.com, it is now $125 each way per pet.
Each way?
Yeah.
Damn.
Okay, well, so the pet's on the plane. It belongs on the plane, and she's trying to. I think Southwest looks bad.
And it looks like they do not allow pets in the cargo area where they let, in some other cases, some other airlines do the cargo area for pets, and Southwest doesn't.
Okay.
So that was her only option.
So she had no other choice but to have it on the plane, which I think is a better choice anyway. I think the cargo, putting a dog in the cargo area is a beating.
Damn, no, $125.
It's a lot of dough, buddy.
Yeah.
Still cheaper probably than whatever. Well, that's Southwest, though. Usually their tickets are pretty affordable.
So it says on Alaska, it's $100 to bring a small dog on as a carry-on.
Yeah. Yeah, I know. I thought we used to pay back in the, you know, but it's been a while.
So is it flying out of Texas, two seats behind us, there were two German shepherds sitting in the seats. They were good boys. And that was Southwest.
Okay.
They have like seat belts on and everything.
Yeah, that's what I like. Just sitting there, is the like, dog buckled in? Because at that point, aren't those dogs just as much of a flight risk to fly out of the seat and hit somebody in the head?
I don't know.
What's worse, somebody's laptop or two German shepherds that could maul you in midair if there's turbulence and they flip out?
Well, I don't know if they're going to be flying in the air biting your head or anything like that.
Look, I mean, I've seen Final Destination, and by the way, that's never been in one. We should make that.
What, a flying dog that mauls you?
In Final Destination, like you escape a plane.
I think even Final Destination is like, that's not even believable.
Oh, come on! You're on a plane and the flying dog mauls you. Hey, look, they got snakes on a plane. Why not flying German Shepherd maulers?
We're watching a movie in the Migs household.
Oh!
Got a new movie to recommend, speaking of movies, BJ.
Okay, this is very, very exciting.
We're almost done with watching the latest Fast and the Furious film.
Oh!
Fast X or Fast 10?
Fast 10.
Fast 10.
Like fasten your seatbelt.
That is not what I expected you to say.
No,
I don't know. Something not Fast and the
Have
Furious.
Have you watched Fast 9 or Fast 8? No, you haven't.
Not positive. I've seen a few Fast and the Furious films. I don't always finish them.
All right, you guys watch Mission Impossible.
Yeah.
And you like that one. I think Dead Reckoning is that one.
That was great.
Okay, so
Fast. And by you guys, I don't know if my wife really cared. I loved it, though.
Oh, well, they are entertaining movies.
Yeah.
Danny, of course, you know, he's like, I want it to be about racing. And, you know, like, because that's what the first movie was about.
Yeah. I mean, I have a car race scene so far. I think there's been one. So.
Yeah. Have they gone to the moon? Are they back in space?
No, I'm currently at the part where John Cena just does some crazy stuff on the plane.
Oh, right, yeah.
Like, to escape from the bad guys. And it was awesome.
Of course.
Him and the little son, you know, Vin Diesel's son.
Oh, that's right. How old is little family boy?
Little family? You mean son?
Well, they're family. Everybody's family.
Dude, it's funny how much they talk about family.
Oh, it's so ridiculous.
The entire movie is just about, are you going to get your family?
Yeah, I know. That's
Jason Momoa is I almost said a bad word.
Oh, is he a real bad guy?
He's great. Yeah.
Oh, but he's a great bad guy.
He's a great bad guy.
Oh, that's fun.
He gives me like this, like Russell Brand on steroids vibe in the movie. I don't know. He's just a whack job, but it's good.
I forgot he was in it.
At first, I wasn't really feeling the film. And then I switched on the closed caption because we talked about that last time. I was watching the Mission Impossible movie with closed caption. It made it more entertaining. I was like, man, I'm not tracking. I put on the closed caption. I've been enjoying this film so much more.
Dude, do you know how
it's
many,
a game changer.
Do you know how many movies you might like now?
I know.
This is really sad for me that all the movies you thought, not a big deal, I don't care. And I'm like, but these were blockbusters. It could be you just didn't know what the hell was going on.
It could have been like I've just got so sick of adjusting the volume there on the movie that I missed out on some important parts because it was being whispered.
Yeah, you're right. I'm with you. Dude, I've had that problem for a long time just with my hearing anyway. So you're right. It's a game changer when you can actually understand what they're talking about.
The weird part, though, with the closed captioning, I know I'm probably speaking to the choir when it comes to like anyone who's watched the movie with closed captioning, but it's like sometimes you have like people talking in the background where I never really even thought about what they were saying, but with the closed captioning, they tell you what they're saying.
It's kind of
like,
cool.
Whoa, this is creepy. Like, I know I feel like I'm eavesdropping.
Yeah, it's really cool when you, like, and sometimes it helps. Oh, or like there's a newscast on, and normally you couldn't hear what the hell the TV was saying, but they'll close caption what the TV newscast is saying, and you're like, oh, I think this is probably a good part of the movie.
And a dumb benefit of it all, which I think is kind of cool, is at least with the Fast and the Furious one, with the closed captioning, they tell you the song that's playing.
That's nice.
I mean, it had the lyrics, of course, but it was like, oh, here's Main Skin. I'm like, oh, dude, this song's awesome.
That is a bonus for closed captioning because I have really downloaded a lot of music because I heard a song that I like.
Yeah, this song's cool.
But I'd be like, I don't know who the hell this is unless you Shazam it. But now closed caption, you know exactly who it is.
Yeah, it starts off, they say the title, and then they have the lyrics.
It's pretty sweet.
Yeah, I don't know. I know a lot of people have already been watching movies with closed captioning and they're like, oh, okay, yeah, welcome to the party.
First you get the fake grass.
Yep.
Now you're closed captioning. You know what's happening to your life right now. It's not good.
Oh, man, this is crazy.
Yeah,
I still like dogs, though. So,
yeah, well, look.
I think that the first five games of a season are important in football. So, I mean, I'm not completely lost my mind.
Okay, not yet anyway. But we're watching you. Believe me, we are watching you for all the signs.
But you're right, though. There might be a few movies that I've dismissed because I was just like, whatever.
I can't blame you. If you're lost and not tracking, you're not going to like anything in life.
This kind of forces you to pay attention.
God forbid that you're forced to pay attention to a movie you're watching. You're right. What is this world coming to?
Damn it, you mean I have to put down my phone and pay attention?
No.
Come on! Vicky, don't even say that to Vicky. Do not ruin her life. Yesterday, Mr. Closed Caption over here, he did get this one wrong.
Mead is primarily made from what?
Mead?
Mead.
Whiskey?
No.
Wool?
No.
Cotton?
No.
Did you say cotton?
Yes.
Okay.
Doesn't sound very tasty.
No, but let's give it a shot. We were looking for honey, actually. You want a shot at beating Steve? You got a 206-803-ROCK. We're playing Beat Migs. Going to do that at 850 on The Rock.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. He's here right now and has agreed to answer more of your questions about bankruptcy. Here's another question from a listener. I'm getting my wages garnished. Can bankruptcy help with that?
Absolutely. One of the big reasons people file bankruptcy is because they have a judgment or a lawsuit against them, or their wages are getting garnished, and so they can't pay their other regular ongoing bills. People sometimes think that you can't file bankruptcy once they have a judgment against them or once a garnishment has started, and that's not true. Filing bankruptcy will immediately stop any garnishment that you have going, except for child support, and stop your creditors from continuing on with garnishments of your bank account, your wages, and in most cases will discharge that liability through the bankruptcy process. And we can file a bankruptcy case for you usually the day you come in.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at choosetherightchapter.com. That's choosetherightchapter.com. Thanks for listening.
Getting older means a world of change, but some things still stay the same, like being at risk for type 1 diabetes, because type 1 can happen at any age. So screen it like you mean it. If just one person in your family has type 1, you're up to 15 times more likely to get it too. And 50% of type 1 diagnoses happen after the age of 18. So screen it like you mean it. Type 1 diabetes starts long before you need insulin, and one blood test could help you spot it early and lower the risk of serious complications like diabetic ketoacidosis, known as DKA. So don't get caught by surprise. Screen it like you mean it, because getting answers now can help you get prepared. The more you know, the more you can do. So don't wait. Talk to a doctor about how to get screened. Tap now or visit screenfortype1.com to learn more. Again, that's screenfortype1.com. And screen it like you mean it.
Hidden fees, restrictive healthcare networks, and confusing coverage are signs that your health insurance isn't really working for you. Christian Healthcare Ministries is the biblical alternative to health insurance, with flexible, affordable healthcare programs and the ability to choose your provider without network restrictions. You can finally have freedom over your healthcare decisions. And when you join, you're surrounded by fellow believers who offer spiritual support. Learn more by visiting chministries.org/solution.
When making a real estate purchase, partner with an agent who is a realtor. We're experts in what we do, with access to exclusive tools and proprietary market data. We're Realtors, members of the National Association of Realtors. That's who we are.
How many carbs are in this cheeseburger? I think it's 15 grams for a slice of bread. How many carbs are in these fries? Take a break with the MiniMed 780G insulin pump system. You don't need to be exact with carb counts. Your best guess is good enough. Visit MedtronicDiabetes.com/780G system to learn more. System is for people with type 1 diabetes ages 7 and over. Prescription required. Warning. Do not use SmartGuard feature for people who require less than 8 units or more than 250 units of insulin a day. See bit.ly/780G risks.
Dealing with an accident and injury claim can be overwhelming. Let Phillips Law Firm fight for you. We understand the pain and suffering, and we're here to guide you through. Call 1-800-JUSTICE today for a free case review, or visit justiceforyou.com and let Phillips Law Firm help you on the road to recovery.
Looking to give the gift of pleasure? Add a little high heat to keep the desire burning. Or maybe you just need a little self-care. Come to Lovers for the best lingerie and toys to keep things hot this holiday. Save 20% on your purchase with Lovers Afterglow Rewards. Just mention LOVE20 at one of our 18 Western Washington locations. Offer valid with free Lovers Afterglow Rewards membership until November 30th. Some exclusions apply.
Your home is going into foreclosure and you feel like a financial wreck. You don't know where to turn for accurate information.
I'm bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagne. Let's talk about some legal options. If we work quickly, we can propose a plan to save your home, modify the loan, or in many cases, even eliminate your second mortgage. The consultation is free. I've helped hundreds of people just like you make informed decisions about whether to save their home or exit it on a reasonable, organized timeline. The chapter you choose sets the tone for the next chapter of your life. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle, Friday, November 17th, 7 p.m. Join us as Live Day goes to prom night. Oh, yeah, Snoqualmie Casino, we're all going to be there.
And we're all going to be dressed up in our favorite prom attire, whatever that means.
Usually something, well, outside of you and your tracksuit, of course. Everybody else probably will wear something sort of looking like it's a tuxedo or a suit.
I'm going to buy one of those tuxedo shirts. I thought I'd go my entire life never owning one, but here we are.
Very excited for you.
Thank you.
Now, we are awarding a prom king and prom queen. So, yes. I mean, if you do really get all dolled up, you could, I don't know what you get for being a prom king or queen.
Something cool.
Yeah, like the status.
Yes,
yeah,
bragging rights.
That's it. And we are doing the whole thing live, like we always do on Live Day, which means on Friday night, all of the sound effects, music, special guests, all the everything will be done live. If you want to join us at Snoqualmie Casino, Friday, November 17th, 7 p.m., tickets on sale now at snocasino.com.
Let's play Beat Migs.
It's time to play the game. Do everybody scream his name. Beat Migs, don't be a loser.
Ready to be Migs. I know Sean from Tacoma is. Sean, are you there?
Yes, I am.
All right, Steve, now get out.
Goodbye.
For those playing at home, Sean has 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. You can pass all you want, but you will only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
Let's go. Oh, yeah.
When it comes to horror movies, what is the first name of the Bride of Chucky?
Pass.
What is the term for animals that are active during the night?
Nocturnal.
Yes. What is the only U.S. state to border Maine?
New Hampshire.
Yes. Which planet shares its name with a chocolate bar?
Mars.
Yes. Usher had the 2000s hit song titled Love in This What?
Yeah.
The Pythagorean theorem only works with what type of triangle?
Isosceles.
No.
Choose.
No.
Pass.
Pete's Super Submarines was the original name for what restaurant chain?
Subway.
Yes. Roger Federer is famous for playing what sport?
Tennis.
Yes. What color does dress does fictional character Wilma Flintstone typically wear?
Blue?
No.
You were close. That was Betty, actually.
You get 5 correct, though, yeah. Sean. All
he
right.
He picked the right color dress of somebody.
Somebody, yeah, but yeah. Not the right person.
No.
Hey, at least Sean did way better than
why do I know that,
the
by
contestant
the way?
Earlier. I don't know.
I know the other answer, too. Why are those 2 facts in my head?
For moments like these.
I forget so many other things that are important in life, but I know that.
Steve, are you ready?
Oh, yeah!
When it comes to horror movies, what is the first name of the Bride of Chucky?
Jennifer.
No.
Oh, it's Jennifer Tilly. That's all I know.
Yep. Yeah. Hey. Nice work.
Bride of Chucky. Chuckette?
No.
Chuckette.
Charlie?
No. What is the term for animals that are active during the night?
Nocturnal.
Yes. What is the only U.S. state to border Maine?
New York.
No.
New England.
No.
New Hampshire.
Yes.
Whatever.
Which planet shares its name with a chocolate bar?
What's that?
Which planet shares its name with a chocolate
bar? Mars.
Yes.
Not Usher. Uranus. They don't want to eat that chocolate bar.
Wow. Someone does. Usher had the 2000s hit song titled Love in This What?
Love what?
Usher had the 2000s hit song titled Love in This What?
Love in This World?
No.
Love in This Planet?
No.
Love in This Body?
No. The Pythagorean theorem only works on what type of triangle?
Isosceles.
No.
Obtuse.
No.
Right angle.
No. Yes? Pete's Super Submarines was the original name for what restaurant chain?
Jersey Mike's.
No.
Subway.
Yes, but you are too late. And with that, you get four correct, which is a loss. 5-4.
I would have dang also it, protested somebody. That triangle.
Go, Sean.
Nice work, Sean.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Good job, buddy. Thank you for playing it. Thank you for giving me my song.
Oh, yeah. Here we go, baby. I'm a loser. Tough loss.
I don't know about that triangle answer.
Me neither.
Do you know the actual answer that I was looking for?
I know it's not. I can't think of it, but it's not right angle.
It's right triangle.
Yeah, that's not the same thing.
Yeah.
I don't think you
is
should.
Is that not?
Yeah.
No, but I appreciate you giving
right,
it to me.
Well, right. I don't know, because a right triangle has a right angle. Right, oh, this yeah. level.
I'm not saying it doesn't have a right angle in the right triangle, but, I mean, if the name of it is right triangle.
Well,
right
I said what type of triangle.
Yeah, a right triangle, like okay. an isosceles.
Well, then you only got three correct. You still lose.
Yeah, goodbye. At least in my opinion. I'm not a math expert, so maybe I'm wrong.
I don't know.
But I'm going to say I'm right.
But are you a triangle expert?
No, I am not. No. That's the sad thing. I suck at that.
Anyone know the bride of Chucky's first name?
Danny is like all indignant and looking down on us that we don't know this.
Was I? I had the blindfold on, so yeah. I couldn't tell.
Oh, yeah. No. When the caller didn't get it right, you were unless you were mad about something else, you had this thing like,
No, again, I just think it's funny when like they just don't answer a bunch in a row. And I was like, maybe he did or maybe he didn't. I don't know. I don't know what my face was, BJ, but it's Tiffany.
It is Tiffany. You are right.
Yeah. I'm glad I knew who played the role.
Yeah, I knew that too, but I didn't even, I don't know her name. I know the actress, but yeah. I don't know the person who's actually, you know, the name of the, so Tiffany? Yep. So there's Chucky and Tiffany.
Yeah.
Okay, then.
I love them. Usher had the 2000s hit song titled Love in This What?
Who was Azure, you said?
Usher.
Oh, Usher. That's I couldn't hear what
you were.
That's what I was hearing in my head.
I'm getting everybody ready for the Super Bowl, okay?
Yeah. Oh, no, Usher, yeah. Oh, it's
love
yeah.
in
it's,
this.
It's love in the right triangle.
Love in this club.
Love in this club.
Love
in this club.
I want to make love in this club.
I'm not wrong, though. If you're making love in the club, you got to be in the right triangle. That's all I'm saying.
Okay. And then you finally got that Subway was Pete's Super Submarine's original name.
That should have been my first
Jersey Mike's. I like how it's like Pete was like, you know what? I'm not going to use my name. I'll use Mike's name instead.
Maybe Uncle Mike was like, look, man, hey. I gave you most of the money for you to make this business. It should be named after me.
Okay, fair enough.
And then two, you didn't get to. Roger Federer is famous for playing what sport?
Tennis.
Yes.
See, look at you.
And what color dress does fictional character Wilma Flintstone typically wear?
Wilma blue.
No.
Oh, that's Betty.
White.
Yeah, white Wilma. How about you know that? You and I, why do we have that in our heads?
I don't know.
Why
do
we have
it.
The color of their dresses in our heads?
Because I can picture the characters pretty quickly.
What color cloth did Fred wear?
Orange.
And Barney?
Barney, ooh. Was Barney brown?
There you go. Why do we have this in our heads? Why?
Because we're stupid.
And is Pebbles purple, I think?
Green, I thought.
Oh, was she green? Okay, see, I can't remember Pebbles.
I had a Google image all of this.
Dino's purple. That's
the
right.
Dinosaur.
That's, yeah, the dinosaur's pet. Purple. I don't know about, and Bam Bam, was he?
He had the gold, like he had like a
cheetah print?
Yeah.
Ah, yeah, I didn't remember the kids. I only remember the hot moms.
Okay.
Were you more of a Wilma or a Betty kind of guy?
Oh, I was totally a Betty kind of guy. And look, I'm going to admit this right now.
You're like a redhead kind of person, though.
I do. But, you know, here's the... You're not going to like this. I shouldn't admit this, but I'm going to say it.
Oh, boy.
I am going to say it. Okay. You know, I became a Betty person. I don't think I should say it. You guys are going to laugh at me.
It's too late. You have to say it.
I really, really liked Rosie O'Donnell's Betty in The Flintstone. She did it for me. I was just like, I like this a lot.
Huh.
Yeah. And I mean, people probably go, are you crazy? You were hot for Rosie O'Donnell. I go, well, I was when she was Betty.
Yeah.
Steve's face is priceless.
No, I know. That's why I didn't want to tell you because I can see your face. It's just not your cup of Betty.
But that doesn't change my opinion of you.
Oh, really?
No.
Oh, that's good to know.
No, who do I care?
Well, right. I don't know. I was really worried. I didn't know if you would care or not.
It does look like you're judging.
No, I just figured you'd go with Wilma. I mean, you know, she's got the red hair.
Listen, and I forget.
Sometimes like some good bullet on her head. I don't know.
And I really did like the actress that played Wilma. I can't remember her name. Elizabeth something, I think. Who was Wilma in the
Wasn't it the person that played Howard Stern's wife in that Private Parts movie?
Oh, was it?
I don't know.
Oh, gosh.
I could be wrong.
Yeah.
Elizabeth Perkins.
Yeah, Elizabeth Perkins. Yes.
No, it's not the person. But
Elizabeth Perkins was Wilma.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like Elizabeth. You're right, Steve. And Elizabeth Perkins, I really like. But all of a sudden, I was like, what is it? Why am I gravitating towards Betty in this movie? I should be all over Wilma. You're right. I do. You're right. I got no excuse.
Interesting.
Nothing at all. I mean, though my true crush was, you know, Rick Moranis as Barney. But, you know.
Rick Moranis as Barney yeah. was pretty awesome.
It was.
I kind of want to watch that movie again.
You think it's bad? I think it might be bad.
Why? It's the Flintstones. It can't be bad.
I feel like it might not hold up, even though, I don't know. And John Goodman was Fred, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it was fun. I remember I liked it, but I don't know if it's good. It's hard to say.
Okay.
Because I haven't seen it in so long, I don't want to stand behind it. All right. It is time for Listeners on the Loose. You pick the topic. You guide the show. 206-803-ROCK, the number to call, the number to text. Whatever you want to talk about, we'll take those calls. We'll take those texts at 919 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. It's Listeners on the Loose, brought to you by Spot Hero. Where'd you park? 206-803-ROCK, the number to call, the number to text. Listeners on the Loose. But do remember, when you call in, follow Steve's rule.
It's a simple rule, BJ, and it's to show some energy and bring it. Otherwise, we're going to have to gong you. And then say goodbye.
Goodbye, old friend.
206-803-ROCK, the number to call, the number to text. Joe Dredd in Seattle, you are on The Rock. Hey, buddy.
Good morning, my friends.
What you got for us, Joe?
Well, earlier, Steve was talking about how he saw the new Fast and the Furious movie, right?
Yeah, you watched Fast 10.
Yeah, I haven't seen it yet myself, but he did mention about how well of a bad guy that Jason Momoa played in that film.
Awesome.
And that reminded me, I don't know if you guys know this, but Jason Momoa has his own vodka that he's promoting.
Wait, a celebrity has their own booze? Come on.
I know, go figure that, huh?
So is that why he was in town?
Oh, no, he's still in town. That's why I'm calling. He's doing appearances today promoting that vodka where you can actually meet him and buy a bottle of it. And I thought maybe Vicky or even Sarah would be interested in knowing where he will be.
Well, I mean, I'm a fan of Aquaman. I like to see where he's at.
Yeah, Steve wants to know if he can give him a present.
Okay, well, I'm not sure where he's going to be in Bellevue, but I heard he's going to be in Bellevue at 10 a.m., but he will be at the QFC in University Village at 2 o'clock from 2 to 2:30.
No way. I wonder if he's coming to Puyallup at any point.
Oh, look at you now. Is Puyallup so special now?
Yeah, we got alcohol there.
As far as I know, those are the only two stops in Seattle. That's
right. We're talking about, you know.
Because our buddy Cool Keith does all of our t-shirts over at Inker Prints, and he's an awesome, awesome dude. And I saw on his Instagram, he had a picture of him with Jason Momoa, and I'm like, what in the world's going
on here?
Keith
just got a lot cooler.
Yeah, now I'm watching Fast 10. I kind of want Keith to punch him in the face for how he is.
And picture of Cool Keith and the picture you showed me, him and Jason Momoa, they look like they're brothers.
They do look like they're related because they both have like these crazy hats on.
Wanted to let you guys know.
Thanks, buddy.
You know, I think Vicky would be more interested than Sarah, but I'm not sure.
I mean, I do have a Jason Momoa mug that Sarah got me, so you might say I'm a fan.
Yeah, she's been a fan of him ever since the Khaleesi days.
Yeah.
So what's the name of his vodka?
Meili, I believe. Meili vodka.
Meili, or how do you spell that?
M-E-I-L-I.
Oh.
Meili.
Yeah, that's what it says on their website.
I know, I pronounce it Meili.
Yeah.
Oh, Meili, very nice. I am, you know, I don't, that's, he could have come over here and probably would have been able to get on our show, especially if he brought a free bottle of vodka.
If he wanted it bad enough.
Yeah, you're right.
Guess here I am talking about his movie. Wouldn't that have been funny if he was listening?
And if he just drove on over, man?
Or he just called in to bitch about how he's like, screw you, my character's a good guy.
Oh,
I don't
know why. Oh, man. Meanwhile,
since try his vodka, though.
Yeah, I mean, look, I'll try anybody's booze.
Yeah, once.
Yeah, definitely. Though, have you seen the big controversy about The Rock, which I kind of am on his side for this is the first time I'm on The Rock's side.
What did The Rock do now?
The Rock didn't do anything. It's this this wax museum in Paris.
Oh, I did see that, yes.
Where they made a white rock.
I had a few people tag me and go, that's cool that they made a wax version of you, but you look a lot bigger than you really are. And I was like, what are you talking about? And I clicked on it, and I was like, oh, that's actually pretty funny.
Dude, it is trippy how do you make a wax museum figure, which is supposed to be exactly like the guy? I mean, they try to make it realistic. They put him in this sort of like dad outfit that you never see The Rock wear. So he looks like he's ready to, you know.
Oh, he's got like a polo shirt on. He's showing off his muscles. I mean, it is definitely a more formal looking version of The Rock.
And
it looks like him, just pale.
Yeah, he's, and so The Rock, and I forget, some comedian did a whole bit about it, the fact that The Rock does not, he's not that light. And so that's the big controversy is like, and he doesn't usually wear that kind of clothing.
It's not often you see The Rock like that. He's typically wearing Rock Under Armour apparel.
Yeah, and so it's really weird. But he looks completely pale there, and I don't know if I've ever seen The Rock that pale.
No, in my life. That looks like they should have at least put like a ghost next to him. That way it's The Rock when he sees a ghost.
Yeah.
I don't know.
And also, here's how you know it's not really realistic. There's no Terramana to be found.
That's true.
You know, it's got to be that. So I was like, I was on The Rock's side thinking like, you know, how do you get that wrong? How do you not, like, if you're going to make a lifelike image of somebody, how do you not make sure that you get their skin tone right?
Especially that. You would think somebody who, like, put it in wherever it goes, hey, guys, are you going to finish coloring this in? Because this doesn't look like him.
It's Terramana Blanco.
That's what he's promoting.
Blanco.
Yeah, that's a big fail because it look. Otherwise, I mean, I think it looks very much like him facially structure. And
so, did The Rock say, "Hey, fix it"? Because that'd be a weird thing. I'd almost be like, "I'm honored that you even made me." So whatever.
There was a I can't remember the comedian's name, but he did a whole shtick on it and tweeted, retweeted, and so I don't know if The Rock himself has commented.
James Jefferson, and yeah, yes, thanks. He said that he's having his people reach out to the Wax Museum to get this fixed.
Okay, so the Rock does like okay.
It'd be funny if The Rock showed up with like a box of crayons and he's just standing outside of him, just kind of like I'm fixing it myself.
He did say though, next time he's in Paris, he'll stop in and have a drink with himself.
A Terramana.
Well, duh.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, that's So that I thought that was a very, very, very cool thing that was running around, and I thought, man, this is killing me. I have to be on his side.
That had to be like one of those high of highs, low of lows. Not low of lows, but you know what I mean. Like here, they're making a wax version of me. What an honor! And then you see, like, this is not good.
No,
like that's kind of like a bummer. Like here, you are being like immortalized, and then all of a sudden, you're like. I do not look like this.
No, it's very bizarre. 206-803-ROCK, the number to call, the number to text. It is Listeners on the Loose.
I also want to know, has any of you guys watched that movie on Netflix, Old Dads, yet?
Oh, yeah. As a matter of fact, I have.
I kind of have.
Oh, what does that mean in your language?
Well, my review's quick. I think what I've seen so far has been pretty freaking funny. But when you're married to someone who really gets uncomfortable with the F word being used as frequently as it does, this was not the movie.
Bill Burr is not your guy.
I could feel, not, yeah, I love Bill Burr.
Well, I mean, if
the wife's
key. Yeah, yeah.
I could feel the uncomfortableness. I wanted to see how long I could go. And eventually she just closed her eyes and fell asleep. I think she just threw in the towel because I was like, and in my head, I'm like, we should put the closed captioning on. I'm like, oh, I don't need it. Every word's the F word in this movie. And he just says the F word like every other word.
You know, it's interesting. I swear that Netflix doesn't edit movies because they want you watching longer. So I think that had this movie been released to a movie theater, it would have been shorter and would have made it better. That doesn't mean there's not a lot of great scenes in the movie and not a lot of, you know, funny moments. And look, it's definitely a fun watch. You got Bill Burr, Bobby Cannavale, and Bokeem Woodbine as the main characters. And also his wife is Jenny from The League.
I only know who Bill Burr is in this whole situation.
Oh, yeah. Well, you watched The League back in the day. Yeah, I was looking at Katie, and I'm like, how do I know that? How do I know her? How do I know her? And then eventually I figured out in my head, oh, it's Jenny from The League. That's fun. I haven't seen her in forever.
I do love how he just kind of, I mean, just goes full bore against the whole cancel culture world that we're in. And there's a moment when he's pissed off all, like, because he's a dad, and he's an older version. You know, he's obviously in his 40s or whatever, and he said something to upset somebody at the school, and then he had to apologize. It's so funny. Like, just because it's just like, I get it. I think we have lost our minds. And it's a pretty fun, over-the-top version of how people will want to cancel everybody for anything.
And you haven't seen the whole movie, so you don't sort of see this go full circle.
Oh, I had to imagine that all of a sudden he has a heart or something like that. And something happens. You know, I mean, like, it seems like
it's my story.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, because look,
I mean, a therapist and
exactly.
Oh, I don't want to see that.
Yeah, Bill. I mean,
I'm glad I stopped when I did. He's still mad, and he's still.
He's not wrong. He's not wrong for how people are just ridiculous, you know, in our society. But at the same time, there was a complaint from a lot of people like, dude, what is going on? You're just angry at everything.
Yeah.
And
well,
that's...
You call people the C word?
Yeah, which, okay? Again, you know, as it turns out, you know, I mean, I feel like that person, okay, maybe that's not the right word to call that person, but they were very snarky, very condescending, you know, and I think deserved of at least some talking to, like, don't be that kind of jerk to me. But yeah, the C word may have been a bit rough.
Yeah.
But what I really was impressed with is Bobby Cannavale, who usually plays the tough guy. He was the dad. He was the stepdad in Ant-Man, to, you know, Paul Rudd's daughter's stepdad. Bobby usually, like, he plays a lot of good tough guys.
Is he the guy that's trying to fit in by acting younger than he really is in
yes.
this movie? I love his character.
Yeah.
He's
and,
so great.
And also very controlled by his wife.
Yes.
Oh, really, to the point where, like, it gets ridiculous in the movie. But it all gets to come full circle for all the characters, including the fact that, you know, I mean, Bill Burr's character was a little bit like had an anger issue. And it's easy to have an anger issue in cancel culture. I mean, it really, really is. So I really liked it. I thought it was a fun movie. And for everything that you said, Steve, if you really want to take a look at the people railing against ridiculousness, it's a good movie on Netflix. Old Dads.
And if you like creative ways to use the F word, this is your movie. This is a Bill Burr movie.
Oh, so good.
And I knew it going into it. I'm like, I don't think I'm going to last. But then my wife fell asleep, so I got to enjoy most of it until I fell asleep. And I'm like, I don't want to go down this road again with her. So I was just like, yeah. I'm good. I saw what I needed to see, and I enjoyed it.
You missed the happy ending.
I kind of got it now.
Yeah, you kind of did.
88% from the audience, but guess how the critics.
That's why I mentioned editing, because I thought this movie probably is going to get ripped by the critics, because there were some moments where it's like, what are we doing?
24%.
Yeah, that's what I figured.
You know, if you give up after about 40 minutes, it's a short film.
Yeah, you're right. God, it just needs editing. It yeah. really, really does. And Netflix doesn't want that. They want you to watch it for as long as they want you to.
I never thought about it from that perspective, but you're probably right.
Yeah, and that's sad. Because I have to now adjust who I am as a movie person and put up with crap sometimes. It's not good. You pick the topic. You guide the show. It is Listeners on the Loose, 206-803-ROCK. We got more of your calls and more of your texts at 933 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
It's time to talk about Felix, the pet insurance brand made just for cats. Starting at under $1 a day, you can get whisker-to-tail protection with a plan as unique as your cat. Sorry, dogs. This customizable coverage is exclusively for feline friends. Learn more at felixcatinsurance.com. That's felixcatinsurance.com. Get it? Meow.
Insurance is underwritten by Independence American Insurance Company and produced by Independence Pet Group. Pre-existing conditions are not covered. Visit felixcatinsurance.com/terms for all terms and limitations.
This holiday season, make your journey memorable with Travel Centers of America. Visit our one-stop shop for all your holiday travel needs. Fuel up, get snacks, and dine at one of our full-service restaurants. Hit the road with peace of mind knowing we've got you covered. Travel Centers of America.
From the very beginning, your kids mean everything to you. That means you do anything for them, especially if they're at risk. So when it comes to type 1 diabetes, screen it like you mean it. Because even if just one person in the family has it, your child is up to 15 times more likely to get it, too. Screen it like you mean it. Because type 1 diabetes can develop at any age. And once you get results, you can get prepared for your child's future. So screen it like you mean it. Type 1 starts long before there are symptoms, but one blood test could help you spot it early, before they need insulin, and could lower the risk of serious complications like diabetic ketoacidosis or DKA. Talk to your doctor about how to screen for type 1 diabetes, because the more you know, the more you can do. So don't wait. Tap now or visit screenfortype1.com to learn more. Again, that's screenfortype1.com. Screen it like you mean it.
Transit is better with an Orca card. Here's why. One, it's easy. Just tap and pay your way onto Metro and all other public transit around the Sound. Two, your tap shows us when and where you're riding the most, so Metro can serve you better. And three, Orca cards are for everyone. 18 and younger now ride free with a free youth Orca card. So what are you waiting for? Get an Orca card. Tap for transit and make your ride count today. Visit kingcounty.gov/tap for transit.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle. It's listeners on the loose. 206-803-ROCK, the number to call, the number to text.
It looks like we have a couple pop punkers on the loose because a couple of us have some questions about some brand new pop punk stuff. One person want to know, hey, Danny, what do you think of the new Green Day song?
It's awesome. I enjoy this Green Day song a lot, actually. I listened to it this morning for the first time along with everyone else, and it was one of those like, oh, man, it's kind of going back to the American Idiot days.
Yeah, it was the big Odyssey premiere this morning. Was it called American Dream?
The American Dream is killing me.
Yes. American Dream is killing me.
That's it. Wow.
I mean, Billy Joe, you're in the room.
And the album comes out in January.
Yeah, January 19th.
Nice.
And then on the other side of it, someone wanted to know, what'd you guys think of the new Blink record? Has anyone listened to it?
Ooh.
Danny, I know you have.
It is so good. This is the Blink-182 album I've been waiting for.
When did that drop?
Friday?
Friday, yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, yeah, I got to get that. I totally forgot.
I got to say, I've listened to it so many times. Because I'll listen at the gym, and then just once it finishes, I'm like, I'll just listen to it again. And I've done that a lot over the weekend.
So you're like a big fan.
Yeah, this is a great record. This might be the best Blink record I've ever heard.
It's so good.
That is saying a lot.
I mean, obviously, there's been some great songs over the years, but from beginning to end, as a full entire piece, it's pretty phenomenal.
Wow. It's definitely top three for me.
Yeah.
Which is, I mean, it's like the other two are Anthem of the State and Take Off Your Pants and Jacket. So this one being up there with those, it's like, wow, this is incredible. It kind of sounded to me like, I don't know if you listen to Self-Titled, but that was kind of where they went a little bit like off the pop punk, you know, era.
It got overly produced.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't hate that
album. I still like the record.
No, yeah. I love that album, but this sounds like the album they should have released after that one. Because it was kind of like one of those, like, they're experimenting with a bunch of different sounds and it's just so much life stuff has gone into them and into it. It's just awesome.
They definitely, they sing a lot about what's going on in their world.
See, that's what I'm loving.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because obviously they're older and have been through it. And it's like, I've often wondered, like, how is Blink going to be able to do that?
But they still have a couple of songs that you just like are complete goof songs.
Yeah.
So it's not like as if they get completely like, well, we're taking ourselves seriously. And we're like, you know, Blink-182 all lowercase. So now we're serious. I guess. like they still have silly songs in there. And you know what? I was watching that interview that they did with like that Zane guy that's on their YouTube.
Zane Lowe. Yeah.
Yeah. And it's a really good interview. And at one point they said they put a lot of things through the filter of what would the Beastie Boys do? And other bands too, like Fugazi and these bands. And I listened to this record, and there's like one song that's like a 1 minute punk, like I think it's called like F Off or something along those lines. And it hit me. I'm like, they kind of are they're a pop punk version of the Beastie Boys. Like there's a certain level of like, you know, like they're conscious of where they're at their age and they're still having fun, but they're not completely like what they once were. They're not trying to hold on to being young. They're still like, they're growing old, but still having fun along the way. And I was like, there's a Beastie Boys vibe to them that I never really even realized until they brought it up in their interview.
It's not easy to do.
No.
You know, it's not easy to do to be able to grow gracefully in music.
Yeah, I'd say that's a top five record of the year for me.
First
or second. And I was about to say, well, you know, there's still time left. I'm like, oh, crap, we're almost in November. So.
Yeah, you are.
There really isn't.
Yeah.
And another thing, too, for me is that, like, I had a friend. I was talking about it with a friend, and he was just like, you know, Tom is back, but not just in terms of being back in the band. But he's kind of just back to being the Tom from Blink-182 that we all kind of miss. Because for a while, I mean, not saying that he, you know, he did his own things, his artistic things with Angels and Airwaves and the movies and the aliens and all that kind of stuff. But, like, hearing him talk in that interview is kind of like, oh, Tom is really kind of like humbled himself. And I think that everything they've been through, like the divorces, the cancer scares,
Travis,
it's like that just really kind of brought him back to, hey, this is the core.
And over the weekend, they played that When We Were Young tour. And one person just texted and said, I was down in Vegas this past weekend for the When We Were Young tour with Blink-182, Green Day, Offspring, Rise Against, Simple Plan, and so many more. They did not disappoint.
Including Danny's favorite band.
Simple Plan?
MXPX.
Yeah.
Oh,
they were there too.
Literally every band that I wanted to see in my entire life played that festival.
Didn't you have tickets to this?
I did have tickets.
Why didn't you go?
And
Green Day did like a secret show too, or not so secret show?
I forgot about that you had tickets to this. That's why I was surprised when you. So what happened? What?
Well, let's just say
personal stuff.
No, I mean it was just, you know, expenses came up at the end of the year, and
I even though
I'd already bought the tickets, it was like buying two plane tickets. I had two tickets. Buying two plane tickets, getting down there, and realizing that
all the
Joe
secret
could buy
shows.
His own ticket for a change.
You think. No. But it was like, yeah, at that point, just realizing how much money I was going to actually spend there and realizing that the holidays are coming up. I have a daughter. It was like, well, this is growing up.
Yeah, this is growing
I'm
up.
I'm sure if you explained it to Lily, like, look, it was you or Blink 182. Okay.
Can we just talk? Here's the real, the alcohol consumption yes. is very expensive for both of them.
That's fair.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's the problem. The hotel or plane fare, that's not a problem. It is the copious amounts of alcohol that you boys do.
And all the merch, too. Every single band had, like, special merch. I was like, how do they expect us to like just buy everything?
$40 a shirt, right?
Yeah, if you're lucky.
Yeah. Oh, Blink. Even 50 is... Oh, yeah.
Blink has a song on their record called When We Were Young. I mean, this whole thing is crazy.
Yeah.
It's kind of nuts. Although, I like this text. Green Day's song is not that great, and Blink 182 are whiny bitches, you douches.
Okay, cool.
I don't disagree with anything that was said right there.
I did not mean to text that to you. I was texting that to Vicky. I hit the wrong number again. It's really funny. There's a guy that I know that plays board games, and he looks just like Danny. And so at first I thought when I saw his post on Twitter that it was Danny at When We Were Young. Uh-huh. He dresses like Danny. He's got like the same kind, almost like he's got the hair, all of it. The black t-shirts,
I
everything.
I want to see this guy.
His name is Roy Cannaday. And the only thing
like
is...
Like the dog food?
Yeah.
Is he a part of that family?
If he is, he's a happy boy.
If not, I'd like to talk to him. Very
yeah,
cheap.
Exactly.
And Lulu loves their food.
Yeah. And I crack up because they do the same things. They like the same music. They look the same. And I don't know if you do a search on Twitter, you might see some of his posts, Danny, from When We Were Young. And
is that the guy?
That's the guy. But you got to get the When We Were Young to see his colored hair. And yeah, the only thing is the beard. That's the only difference that you know that you guys have is that he has a beard and you don't. But he reminds me so much of you, especially all the things he's into. Including
someone said they were there and it cost $150 for zip up hoodies.
$150 for zip up hoodies.
What is the profit on something like that?
Wow.
Yeah. That guy doesn't remind me of Danny at all.
No? Doesn't make you think of Danny?
No, he's just a dude with blue hair.
All right, there you go.
Well, never mind then. Maybe Danny just reminds me of Danny.
Oh, that works.
Yeah.
And
Like, what do you make? Like, how much are those zip-up hoodies costing? Like, under $10.
Probably. Oh, you're asking me? Yeah, because, well, you know, I make them. Yeah, what do you want to know? Usually, Joey and Sarah, I don't pay them much.
Even if they cost you $20 a pop, which I don't think that's even what they cost. I bet they're under $20 a pop to make a zip-up hoodie, screen printed, whatever. And you're charging $150?
That's how we do it on Shark Tank, Mr. Wonderful.
No, dude, I mean, if people are paying for it, I mean, how am I to blame them? But that's insane.
Yeah, I don't get surprised anymore. Because, again, you watch Shark Tank and you hear about the markup and how much something costs to make and how much they need it to be in order for the sharks to back these people. Mm-hmm. And you're like 50%. Mark, like profit, sometimes it's not enough. They're going, wait, it costs you $10 to make this, but you're only charging 20. No, I need it to be 40, or either that, you need to find a way to make it for like $3. Yeah, it's just,
Then the band, I'm sure if they hear me say that, they'll screw off. How much money do I make off of people listening to our record online? And I'm like, that's a very good point. Like, you could get a billion streams and you're getting dollars back.
Yeah.
And that's the hard thing. You know, these bands got to make money somehow. You're right.
Right. But it's still. Hurts my soul that you're trying to charge $150 for a zip-up hoodie.
Well, dude, and I was just thinking about like the ticket-wise.
Wear it.
Like, I wonder how much they made to play that festival because there were so many bands, and the tickets were not cheap. I mean, the general, like, they had so many different tiers that you could do, and I just bought general GA tickets, and for two of them, it was over $800.
Well, and you got to wonder if the venue got a piece of
$800 for a pair of tickets.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, I wonder.
For one day. Not, that wasn't 2 days. That was one day.
Do you think the venue gets any part of the merch sales, too? Because, I mean, there are deals out there that are crazy, and so...
Yes, there are some. And I know that there's some places that have stopped doing that, but there were some venues where it's like... You basically come in and they will do an inventory check. That way you can't even scam them because they're like, we get X amount of percentage of all the merchandise that you sell.
Yeah.
Which I think is lame. I can understand being like, hey... It's a flat fee of like, you know, a couple bucks just because, you know, that takes up space and, you know, whatever. But there are some that are just like kind of like taking advantage of the band. And it's like, that's unfair.
especially if it's like they have their own merch person selling it. Like it, the whole thing is just crazy. But I know a lot of venues have stopped doing that.
That's good because, I mean, how
it's
are
a
they,
bad look.
How are they supposed to make their cash? I mean, especially if, you know, I don't know how much of really like, you know, how much they're paid as opposed to how much the profit on those tickets are for the venue.
Now, I knew of some bands that they would like smuggle T-shirts into the venues. They're like, I remember one of my buddies, it was like a big touring band, mm-hmm. and it was like a pop punk band too, oddly enough. But they were like, yeah, we have to hide them in this thing and sneak them in this way. That way they can sell the shirts and not get dinged as much from the venue.
So you only are bringing 10 shirts. Is that your inventory? Yeah, we swear. Don't plan on selling many. Nope.
Did you see some of the pictures from the festival, Joe? It looked how great. Many people were there? I think it was 65,000.
Yeah, there were a lot.
And both days. But my favorite part was, like, I wanted to actually go just for the sideshows. There were so many, like, that just popped up random. Like, Sum 41 played at the Punk Rock Museum for a free show with Fat Mike from NoFX. I would have killed to be there. Green Day did that small
maybe
show.
Maybe it's a good thing you didn't. You know, we don't want you going to jail.
Yeah, I mean, she's all of a sudden, it's like, you know, yeah.
400 people in that venue. Like, oh, those would have been the reasons to go to that thing.
Well, that's kind of what you do, though, when you go to shows like that. You know there are going to be those secret Kill Force shows.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you still
do. Do they have a display of wallet chains so that people can purchase?
You know, I would have gone crazy if they did because I need a new one.
But. Do you? All right, well, say Christmas is coming. I'm not going to get it for you, but yeah, Christmas.
We should do a BJ Migs wallet chain.
Oh, my God.
Yes, for that one person that will wear it.
I would buy three, BJ.
There we go. Okay, well, yeah. All right, then that makes up the profit right there.
That's three more sales than our turtle T-shirt right there, right?
I am not shocked. All right, we have, actually, we have more time to take a little couple more listeners. 206-803-ROCK, the number to call, the number to text.
So they said, do you guys think that Geno Smith is being put on on a short leash? Yes.
You know, it's interesting. I don't
By
know.
Fans, if- I think fans are a little out of their mind.
Yeah.
I think it's a little unfair at times. Like, I mean, I'm not saying he's like the perfect quarterback, but I mean, it's not like he played. People are acting like as if he lost the game. I mean, yeah, there was a couple of questionable passes, but I think he'll recover.
There is something that I think the analyst pointed out that I wonder. I'm going to start paying attention to. You know, when he is under pressure, he's not that good. Mm-hmm. Is what was alleged during the last game, and I thought, oh, that's an interesting point. I haven't heard anybody make before. And it is interesting, you know, I mean, he's thrown some bad passes, obviously. He's held on to the ball. He's gotten sacked a couple. So that makes me wonder, like, when he has time, he's amazing.
Yeah. I think having that offensive line the way it is kind of in his head.
Yeah.
Because he probably realizes I only have X amount of time. Oh, look, I don't want to sound like a Geno apologist, but in the same sense, like, man, people, like, he has one. Because on social media, it's like, let's get rid of him. It's time to go. I'm like, they won the game, guys. Like, do you not remember with Russell Wilson, there were a lot of games where you questioned how, granted, like, he would pull it out at the end. But still, I mean, there were some games where you're just like, what the hell is going on here? It's a human position. It's not a robot.
And where are you going to get somebody? Right. I mean, that's
I don't
the
know if Drew Locke's the answer. Some people are like, let's just at least find out if Drew Locke is the answer.
This isn't the time. I mean,
they're 4-2.
Yeah, and if you really want to make the playoffs, you just can't make a change like that. It's not. It's what nobody wants to do. You don't want to have to replace your starter for any reason, and he hasn't been bad enough to go, we need to get him out of the game.
If anything, I have no issues with Shane Waldron, the offensive coordinator. But I feel like it's time to test your creativity because, I mean, that. When they were down that 1 yard line, they ran it like three times, and I'm like, "What are we doing? Like, it's not working."
And
is there something else you guys could do? Is there some kind of way you could kind of change things up a little bit?
Yeah, I you know, and again, we don't know if it's a personnel issue.
It could be offensive line issue with that as well. You're right;
they do have a red zone problem. But again, you know, here's what people don't understand: you're in the red zone. There's less field to defend. You know, which means it is supposed to be tough to score in the red zone because you don't have to worry about all, you know, the entire field you have to cover. And when you're on the 1 yard line, guess what? There's less field to cover, a lot less. And yeah, if you don't have the kind of, you know, offensive line and running back that can just plow Marshawn style, there's a lot to be concerned with. But we have time to figure that out. The good news is if the defense is as good as it is and if it gets better, that may not be a big deal, especially if the defense is, you know, if the offense can stay on the field long enough. That's what I hope, is that the defense gets off the field so quick that their other team's defense is on there so long that fatigue will help.
Plus, I mean, you look at that game. I mean, you have DK's out of the game. You have two rookies that are kind of like he's relying on to play well. And they did. Don't get me wrong. But offensive line, who the hell knows who's playing right now? The backup running back, Charbonnet, was out. I mean, it wasn't like
that was the bad. That he would have been the guy I think you would have run on those first and ones.
At least one of those.
Yeah, first and goals. Yeah. He seems like he can plow a little better, if you will.
Well, I didn't pay attention to him in college, BJ, like you apparently.
Well, I did follow both their careers. And nothing against Walker. He had his fair share of plowing. But boy, the real plow was Charbonnet. But that's another thing. Charbonnet was out. Charbonnet. Yeah. He and Walker are really a good tandem. And so I forgot that, Steve. I'm glad you brought that up because that's another thing that Geno doesn't or Waldron doesn't have it at their disposal. They had a couple of big pieces out.
You know the thing that bothered me the most about that game? I don't know if I like Tariq Woolen going by Reek Woolen.
If anything, he's messing everybody up because nobody can remember. Because
they said something happened and it was a penalty, and it was always Reek Woolen. I'm like, who's this guy that we got playing that like screws things up for us? And I realized, oh, wait, Tariq Woolen.
Yeah.
I was like, I thought it was a different guy. I don't know why, but for some reason it's messing with me.
Do you think he's going to change his name every year?
He should.
I think that would be fantastic.
He's better as Tariq.
So if he's Tariq, then he's Reek this year. He should be Tor, right?
Or Tar,
yeah. He could be that next season.
Tar Woolen.
And then he'll just come up with a whole other name. Or he'll do it backwards. He'll be like, I'm Will Tariq.
Or Eek.
Yeah. Oh, Eek.
Eek Woolen.
All right. It is time to have a big question answered right now. What do Ryan Castle and Mac and Cheese have in common? Ooh. I'll tell you at 9:50 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW. And now, the Ryan Castle question of the day.
What do Ryan Castle and mac and cheese have in common?
My mac is pretty cheesy.
Yeah.
Return of the mac.
Oh my God.
Both are better with cut up hot dogs.
Oh yeah.
Little wieners.
Steve likes the little wieners on both of them.
I ever tell you guys my hot dog mac and cheese story?
It's the greatest story.
I'll make it real fast.
Okay.
I was a very nice restaurant, and I was giving them a hard time about their mac and cheese. I said, the only good mac and cheese has hot dogs in it. And later, mac and cheese showed up with hot dogs in it. The waitress went across the street to the store, bought hot dogs, had them grill it, put it in the mac and cheese, and brought it to the table.
Okay, that was
like the greatest customer service story
so
ever.
So great. Yeah. That is a fancy restaurant. Yeah.
That was, by the way, I'll say it. That was El Gaucho downtown.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, they went and bought hot dogs and put it in the mac and cheese because I was giving the waitress a hard time about it.
Oh, well, I got to tell you this. I mean, nothing against El Gaucho because they're a good restaurant.
Great restaurant.
I am surprised that they went to that level of customer service. That's amazing.
That's what you pay for when you go to El Gaucho.
That's a good thing to pay for. I am right. Man, I'm going to start saying, you know, it's better. Money is really good in my mac and cheese, like $100 bills. How about KFC? Just announced they're bringing back their wraps, and this time there's going to be a mac and cheese version, which is chicken, mac and cheese, and more cheese and a wrap. Let's go.
Sign me up. I'm in.
Limited time, but starts on November 12th, so we have to wait a little bit. I like chicken, and I like mac and cheese. What else do you need?
Know what I'm having for Thanksgiving dinner at my house.
Can I get the invite?
No turkey this year. You're more than welcome.
Yeah.
There's no vegan version of this, though, Steve.
Oh, that's fine.
Yeah, there's a lot in there that just does not work for the big V. I apologize.
You can watch me eat one.
Oh, there you go. That's not a sin. Ryan Castle, he's got a 12-pack. That's next.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. Here's another question from a listener. If I file for bankruptcy, do I have to appear in court? That makes me nervous.
Going to court is never something that's easy to do. However, when you file bankruptcy, you usually only have to attend one hearing at the courthouse. Of course, I'll be there with you. And when you go to court, it's not before the judge. It's actually with the trustee or the trustee's attorney. One of the things that's critical in a bankruptcy is that you give your attorney and the court all of your information. You list all of your assets and all of your creditors. That's what we're trading for your discharge, is your true and honest disclosure of your assets and liabilities. And so the court hearing is just usually about a five-minute deal where you show up and reaffirm and swear that all the information you've given the court and your attorney is correct.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at choosetherightchapter.com. That's choosetherightchapter.com. Thanks for listening.
When making a real estate purchase, partner with an agent who is a realtor. We're experts in what we do, with access to exclusive tools and proprietary market data. We're Realtors, members of the National Association of Realtors. That's who we are.
Are you feeling pressure to choose an insurance plan that doesn't fit your family? You're not alone. This open enrollment, take back freedom over your healthcare decisions with Christian Healthcare Ministries. CHM is the faith-based alternative to insurance that aligns with the values that matter most. Choose a provider you trust with no network restrictions and affordable healthcare programs that work for you. Enroll today at chministries.org/solution. That's chministries.org/solution.
Some companies are big, others are small. To Robert Half, their hiring needs are equally huge. At Robert Half, our specialized recruiting professionals elevate their expertise with proprietary AI tools to transform candidate discovery, assessment, and selection. Whether sourcing talent locally or in any geography that works for you, Robert Half can pinpoint hard-to-find candidates in finance and accounting, technology, marketing and creative, legal, and administrative and customer support. At Robert Half, we know talent.
Selling your car to Carvana is as easy as...
As easy as pie?
Sure. All you have to do is enter your license plate or VIN.
As easy as a stroll in the park.
Okay, then just answer a few questions and you'll get a real offer in seconds.
As easy as singing!
Why not? Schedule a pickup or drop-off and Carvana will pay you that amount right on the spot.
As easy as playing guitar.
Actually, I find that kind of difficult. But selling your car to Carvana is as easy as...
Can be.
Visit Carvana.com or download the app to get an instant offer today.